This is Rogers TV, Gray County.
Race to Halmo, score!
On his own, Kinsett scores!
We're going to the OHL final.
It's been a fun ride.
And the celebration begins. History in the making.
The majors have sealed the deal. They are the Eastern Conference champions in the Ontario Hockey League.
5 decades since this happened, folks.
Between the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors and Owen Sound Attack. Coming up next on Rogers TV, the OHL playoffs so far, they've been chalked. The top two teams during the regular season meeting here in the OHL Championship Series. The Majors, the top team in the entire OHL during the regular season, had the best record. The Owen Sound Attack, the second best record during the regular season and the best record in the Western Conference. The Majors scored the most goals during the regular season. The Attack, the second most. The Majors only lost 5 games in regulation all season on the road. The Attack only lost 5 games in regulation all season at home. An absolutely fantastic matchup here for the start of the OHL Championship Series. Let's look at how the Owen Sound Attack made it here into this Championship Series. Opening round, the London Knights took them to 6 games in maybe their toughest series of the playoffs. Second round, they swept away Plymouth in 4 games. The two-time defending OHL champs, Windsor Spitfires, in the championship, conference championship series. That took 5 games, and the Owen Sound Attack losing 3 games. That's it during the playoffs. They did not lose a single game at home as they head into this game one of the OHL Championship Series. We're almost set for puck drop. Let's send it downstairs.
Scott Stager.
Okay, thanks.
Defense number 2, Keegan Cumming.
Right wing, number 8, Roman Burdnikov. Center, number 9, Jamel Smith. Right wing, number 10, Robbie McNerdy. Center, number 11, Cameron Brace. Defense, number 12, Jesse Blacker. Center, number 15, Andrew Shaw. Left wing, number 17, Garrett Wilson. Center, number 18, Joey Hishon. Left wing, number 19, Andrew Fritsch. Right wing, number 20, Brendan Childerly. Defense, number 22, Matt Petgrave. Defense, number 24, Matt Stanish. Defense, number 26, Jeffrey Shemich. Left wing, number 28, Michael Halmo. And centerman, number 37, Liam Hillness. And the Attack scratches for tonight are goaltender, number 35, Michael Zador. Defense, number 3, Greg Stagger. Defense, number 6, Braden Rose. Left wing, number 25, Daniel Zweep. And right wing, number 29, Curtis Gabriel. The general manager of the Attack is Dale DeGray. The assistant general manager is Ian McClellan. The head coach is Mark Reeds. And the assistant coach is Terry Virtue. The athletic therapist is Andy Brown. And the assistant trainer is Gary Brennan. And now, fans, please welcome your 2010-2011 Mississauga St. Michael's Majors! Goaltender, number 31, Mikael Audet. Goaltender, number 34, J.P. Anderson. Defense, number 2, Dylan DeMello. Right wing, number 4, Justin Shug. Defense, number 5, Stuart Percy. Defense, number 6, Michael D'Orazio. Right wing, number 6, Derek Schoenmakers. Defense, number 10, Brett Fleming. Center, number 11, Casey Sezikis. Left wing, number 12, Jamie Wise. Left wing, number 13, Maxim Kitson. Center, number 14, Corey Bureau. Defense, number 15, David Carrente. Center, number 16, Joe Cramarosa. Center, number 19, Jordan Mayer. Defense, number 22, Mark Kenton. Left wing, number 23, Devontae Smith-Pelly. Left wing, number 25, Riley Brace. Center, number 26, Rob Flick. And left wing, number 28, Chris D'Souza. The scratches for your majors tonight is goaltender, number 30, Taylor Edwards. Defense, number 7, Alex Cord. Right wing, number 17, Justin Rasmussen. Right wing, number 24, Greg Such. And left wing, number 27, Mika Partanen. The general manager and head coach of the majors is Dave Cameron. The assistant general manager and co-coach is James Boyd. The athletic therapist is Ivan Bokanovic. And the equipment manager is Tom Frater. And fans, please now rise and remove your hats and join Mark Cassidy in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you.
That's what's on the line as the Rogers OHL Championship is about to face off. Dan Dunn leaving Roger Lajoie. We welcome you inside to Hersey Center. And head coach Dave Cameron tonight will be under the watchful eyes of referees Dave Lewis out of Whitby, Sean Reed out of Ottawa, Jesse Wilmot of Hamilton, and Matthew Traub of Stouffville. Roger are in the linesmen for tonight as we get a look at the bench for the Owen Sound Attack.
Mark Reed, the OHL's coach of the year, and Dave Cameron, you just saw both of these teams. Of course, the two top clubs in the league. I don't think there's any disputing that. Majors led in points. Owen Sound was second. 12-1, the Majors in the postseason. Owen Sound 12-3. We are ready to go.
The championship is underway, and the Majors with the first push off the faceoff. D'Souza out with Rob Flick and Maxim Kitson. And it's the number one line for Owen Sound. No surprise to start us off here tonight in an early offside. But that number one line, all you have to do is look down your rosters at number 17, 18, and 19. Wilson, Hishon, and Fritsch. And Roger, they have led the way.
They have led the way, and Owen Sound, a lot like the Majors, Dan, a deep team, but there is no question that's the go-to line on this hockey club for Mark Reeds. And the two teams, similar. Well-coached, good goaltending, play good defensive systems.
Chance for Kitson early in the slot. Kitson, and he can't get it by Stager, who got to his left and with the pad down to the post made the stop. Early push by the Majors continues. Percy back at the point along with Fleming, the draft pick of the Washington Capitals. And it's Hishon now who makes the puck find its way under the stick of Wilson, who fires it in. Garrett Wilson, Florida Panthers draft pick, takes the puck deep into Mississauga territory, and it's a deep forecheck put on here by Owen Sound. Majors break out of that pressure with a pass up through center ice. Now Helis with the intercept, and he'll fire it right back in on J.P. Anderson. No surprise getting the start for the Majors. We already mentioned Stager down at the other end. There's a shot that goes off the side of the net by Jesse Blacker, Toronto Maple Leaf draft pick, and Leaf fans have been keeping an eye on his progress throughout the year, and it has been good progress, particularly in these OHL playoffs. Even cutting at his own end. Now to center ice. McNardy fires it in. He'll head to change. J.P. Anderson to leave now for Canton, the veteran who was brought in for this very series and the Memorial Cup. Both of these teams, by the way, if you're just joining us, and need a quick how-to lesson on what's next for these clubs. They're playing for the OHL Championship, Roger, the Rogers Cup, but they're also Memorial Cup bound.
No doubt, both teams have a spot booked, but Dan, I'll tell you what, OHL Championship banner hangs in your arena forever, and Dave Cameron said in the press conference this week, rather win the OHL title, the Memorial Cup, if he had to pick one or the other, and I would tend to agree with him. So there's a lot at stake here. Yes, these two teams are going to play, even the losing team, but you want to win the OHL Championship.
J.P. Anderson called upon to make an early stop. Not much on the shot, though. Corrente, Mississauga native, takes a bump and moves the puck for Canton, gets it back again. Majors, again, if you're new to watching Mississauga hockey, well, what you just saw is a rarity. Usually it's 1-2 and out of the zone, but an icing call against Mississauga.
Scott Stager is the goaltender of the Owen Sound Attack, and boy, has he had a great playoff. 8-1 record, 2.08 goals against average, and a .931 save percentage. It's been by committee goaltending a little bit. Michael Zador has played, Bennington has played as well, but Scott Stager has definitely taken over, battled some injuries at points during the season, but has established himself as a go-to guy here for Mark Reeds.
Yeah, they have a nice 1-2 punch, as you mentioned, in goal in Owen Sound. A number of fans have made the trek here to Mississauga for game number one here tonight. Fired in by Andrew Fritsch, and behind the net, Corrente after it. Wise on the boards in the corner. Takes a hit, turning himself into the glass that time. Puck in the slot, no shot yet, back to the left point. That shot doesn't hit net, it's wide of the mark. Played back to the point. Šemić up top, wires, and that one goes off the back of an Owen Sound player in front. J.P. Anderson holds on. Hit Garrett Wilson first. A shot from Jeffrey Šemić up top.
J.P. Anderson, look at those numbers. 1.68 goals against average. His save percentage, .931. His record is 12-1 in the postseason, among the league leaders in every goaltending category in the regular season, and leading in every category in the postseason. Yeah, maybe there's a little bit of a committee in goal in Owen Sound. There is just one goaltender for St. Mike's.
Interference penalty right off the faceoff. Normally, when you get a whistle that quick off the draw, and when it's your team winning the faceoff, quite often your team is going to the box, not because you won the draw, but because someone's trying to block out, and that's exactly what's happened here. So the penalty call here against Brendan Childerly of Stratford, Ontario, former Sioux Greyhound. Faceoff will come back in the Owen Sound end to the left of Stager. Major still looking for their first shot on goal. Cizikas, Smith-Pelly, and Shug with Percy and Canton. Out there now for St. Mike's.
Major's power play number 6 in the OHL in the postseason.
Stager with the save. Rebound bouncing in front of the net. And the backhand by Stanish goes down the ice. J.P. Anderson back to greet it.
Attack's penalty kill is 7th, so both these teams among the leaders. And Major's power play has struggled a little bit in recent games. Special teams so important when you get into a final series, though.
Maxim Kitson leads the Major's power play with 4 extra strength goals so far in this postseason. He's not on the ice now. Mark Canton up top. Quick puck movement to Shug. In the slot. Smith-Pelly trying to go to the post for Cizikas, and the pass went underneath his stick. Major's keep possession now. 1:14 left in the power play. There's your first of the series. Devontae Smith-Pelly slides it Stager for a 1-0 lead, a power play goal for Mississauga.
Well, your big players have got to be your big players, right? Smith-Pelly, what a time for his 8th goal of the postseason, and he opens the final 3:54 in. Simple give and go pass, and well, Stager just got a piece of that or not. Smith-Pelly perfectly positioned. Went off the Owen Sound defenseman's stick before Smith-Pelly got it. Not much traffic, but Devontae Smith-Pelly, 8th of the season at 3:54. And the OHL final score sheet has a name on it.
So important that Mississauga and Owen Sound, for that matter, have the special teams working early in the series. And the Majors have taken care of their end of the market. Just Jay Gilbert behind the net takes a look. Pressure put on by Jamie Wise, the former Peterborough Pete, on the puck to center ice, and it's past Corrente. There won't be any icing on the play as it's J.P. Anderson out to play it. Linesman had waved it off. DeRizio out there on the back end for the Majors as well. And for the most part, save for that power play, Owen Sound has had most of the possession as Blacker races into the right wing and fires it well wide. Not to suggest the Majors were on their heels 5-on-5 as it's touched by Cramarosa through the legs of Keevan Cutting and deep into Owen Sound territory. But really, for the first time in these playoffs, the Majors finding themselves in their own end a little extra time than they have so far. Niagara was the best challenge to this point, as you would expect would be the case in these playoffs. But these Owen Sound attack are certainly a high step above. Another penalty coming up on the play as Rob Flick is going to go. Even though the puck was touched up by the attack, referee makes the call, and it's Rob Flick going to the penalty box. Interference.
Another interference call, Dan. 5:08 into this period, so Majors took advantage on their power play. Now Owen Sound can answer back, and their power play has answered back big time in the postseason. Number 2 in power play efficiency in this league at 23.9%. Majors' penalty kill has started to slip here a little bit. But so far, so good in the playoffs for the Majors after a tough regular season. So we'll see if the Majors can continue their strong special teams play. But a challenge here. Owen Sound's power play has been working.
Majors putting some pressure on deep early in this penalty kill. They've already knocked off 20 seconds on the man advantage. Wilson gives chase down the right wing. He has Blacker back on the point. Wilson pressured by Corey Bureau. That frees up the puck, and it's Percy who gets it out to center ice and into the Owen Sound end. And they'll start it again with Matt Stanis, the Burlington native, circling his net right up the center with a pass. Wilson with Blacker trailing, standing at the point, waiting for the pass. It won't get there. Instead, it's down the ice. Jamie Wise doing the job. Majors change it up with the two forwards, staying with the Triple twos on the back end of Canton 22 and DeMello number two. They back it up now as Shaw carries in. Here's a pass in front. Nice finish by the power play goal scoring leader for this team. Rami Mignardi has his fifth power play goal of these playoffs, and we are tied at one.
Well, talk about answering back big time. The attack do just that. And when you've got the extra man, you've got to spring the extra man. And they did as Mignardi is sprung. Nice cross ice pass and nobody picking him up. He fires it past Anderson at 6-11. And back-to-back power play goals, one for Mississauga, one for Owen Sound. Hey, is this shaping up to be a pretty good hockey game? 1-1, Mignardi ties the game.
Interference twice, power play goals twice. This is Gilbert to center. Pass to the Majors line, turn back. Canton. Rob Flick just out of the penalty box. With a hit in the neutral zone, fans cheering that on as D'Souza can't get it around Gilbert. Much more aggressive forecheck here by Owen Sound than the Majors have been used to in these playoffs. And it has set them back just a tad. Now trying to have their first push 5-on-5 as Gilbert. Great position on D'Souza. Rob Flick, though, nice trail. Tries a tough angle shot. Stager squeezes the post. The puck is still loose. Stager reaching for it. Now the referee makes the call. With 13:03 to go in the opening period, we're tied at one.
Stager did a nice job there protecting the side of the net, Dan, and hugging that goalpost. And the Majors had nothing to shoot at, even if they'd squirted the puck out. Nice hit by D'Souza to create that opportunity. Look at Stager. Doesn't move. Does not leave that post. Has the big body. He's 6'3". Stretched across. There's no room to put the puck past him. Not a brilliant save, but a nice play and good positioning. He knew exactly where that goalpost was every minute. No room to put that puck in.
Here's some more room on this right wing is Hishon at the top of the circle. Shot deflected and up into the netting. You know, this combination of Stager and Binnington in net for Owen Sound, Roger. It's worked all year, as you mentioned, with injuries. Binnington took over for the most part, but he credits Stager with allowing him to be as good as he could be, and he said that Stager really cheered him on all year long, and that really helped his confidence, and you can see what it did for Owen Sound. It got him here.
Goaltending tandem, you're so right, Dan, and then let's not remember Michael Zadora, who came over from Oshawa, who also got some playing time when Stager was hurt, also contributed. So they had three goaltenders who really did it by committee here in Owen Sound in a year.
There's a shot glove with traffic in front. Smith Pelly. Well, they all bought in. Similar to what's happened here in Mississauga this year. Obviously a different scenario in net. Dave Cameron made a move to get some veteran experience on the hockey club for the Memorial Cup, so he sacrificed a little bit in goal and moving an experienced OHL goaltender in Peters. But yes, between the two teams, there have been quite a few between the pipes this year.
Yeah, Michael Odette, of course, coming over from the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League and has not played a lot for the Majors, has not played 1 minute in this postseason. That's part of the plan. Did get a shutout in his last regular season game, however, and coming over from Ryan Noranda.
Majors with their first real setup, 5-on-5, turned back to their own zone. Riley Brace now with a backhander, and that goes up over the glass. And off the whistle, we've got some pushing and shoving with Schoenmakers and Shemitz. Faceoff will come outside the Owen Sound line. Where are they coming with it? Just outside the blue line or out to center ice? Go to center ice, they've decided.
When you don't know where to drop the puck, that's where you go, center ice. Where do we drop the puck? I'll put it at center. I'm not sure. That's a big answer goal by Owen Sound there, Dan. And talk about an OHL final and first-time franchise in the OHL final, as it is for the Majors since they've been back. Of course, reincarnation of a great old franchise, but that's a big power play goal for the visitors, kind of keep themselves in the game early.
Well, and these two teams, when they meet in the Memorial Cup, we'll get to a little tidbit of information for you if you're watching on Rogers TV. After Corrente moves the puck ahead to Riley Brace. He'll shoot it in, Majors change it up. When these two teams meet in the Memorial Cup, we can let you know that Roger and I, along with Jack Miller, will be part of the first ever Majors Toronto radio broadcast on Sportsnet Radio, the Fan 590. We'll have the All-Ontario matchup in the Memorial Cup on Sportsnet Radio, and we'll have the final, as well as every other game, at Sportsnet Radio's website, fan590.com. And Roger will be calling games along with Jack Miller as well, so we're looking forward to that.
No question about it. What an exciting time. And in a moment, Alicia Warner is going to show you what those tickets look like. The Memorial Cup package tickets. Are they beautiful?
That's a great thing about buying any season ticket package when they do it outright for you. And
oh,
Roger, you showed me before the game. They look great. So give viewers a peek at those in a minute. Right now, it's Berdnikov from Omsk, Russia, trying the left wing, and the whistle sounds with 10:53 to go in a 1-1 game here in period number one.
Well, you know, both these teams will stay disciplined and not try anything really wild. Dave Cameron keeps saying at this time of year, you're a hostage to your players. You have done everything. There's no surprises. Hey, look, the Majors played 68 regular season games, 13 playoff games. This is their 82nd game of the year. Owen Sound probably played two more, I guess, because they're 12-3. What new wrinkles can you possibly come to with 84? Do what works. And obviously, both these teams are in the OHL final. They've done a lot of stuff that works.
Here's D'Souza with a backhand. Nice save. Pad fired out by Stager. And much like Mississauga, very quickly after the save, the puck is out of the zone. Owen Sound attack. Do not waste time. They don't fool around with it. Now it's Percy under pressure. Kitson gets some help from Rob Flick, who'll carry it to his blue line. Little check from behind almost caught him, but gets it out of the zone and into Owen Sound territory. The attack now backed up into their own end. Pass up through center ice. Helas on his tape, trying to split the middle. Nothing there. Trailer on the play. McNarty's shot is blocked, and the Majors counter with Kitson. Rob Flick. Kitson stays with him in front of the net. Pass goes off his skate. Blacker watching Kitson, and now the puck comes near side. Canton comes down from the point uncovered. Nobody back of the point yet. Now D'Souza is there, so Canton took the hit. Kitson with a hit on Blacker as they continue to battle. Now on the far side, it's Maidens. Takes a look. His pass almost intercepted, but Canton at center ice. Back up for the Majors. And the captain offside is D'Souza coming out over on the other side.
9:39 to go in the opening period. We said those Memorial Cup tickets look terrific. Alicia Warner's got one downstairs to show you. Alicia?
I sure do, guys, and you're right. We're not too sure who's going to win this OHL final, but we do know that both of these teams are going to be participants in the Memorial Cup. Lots of people at guest services today picking up their copy of the tickets, which are, like you said, Roger, absolutely beautiful. Not just having to tear them out of the booklet. You can, they are perforated. You can take them out of the book, but you can also keep them as a keepsake as well, if you'd like, as an entire package. You're sitting at home thinking about just how beautiful these tickets would look in your hand. You're still able to order these tickets online. Easiest way to do it is to go to stmichaelsmajors.com and get a set of your own. Guys, we'll throw it back up to you.
Now, are those yours?
Those
she's
are
holding?
My actual tickets.
So they're gone.
They're gone now, so I'm going to have to get two more. Holy smokes.
And by the way, so
and
you saw the little
way,
tickets.
That's one ticket.
Yeah,
that's
but that,
ticket.
The big one in the middle, that was a championship
that's
ticket.
That's the championship ticket. It's huge, and that's one ticket. One ticket for all nine games in the tournament, of course. Just beautiful job on that package. Just terrific.
Garrett
fans,
Wilson.
Get them. And fans in Owen Sound are realizing, Dan, already now, the Owen Sound attack here Saturday, May the 21st, for their first game in Memorial Cup history. That game is getting close to a sellout. So the fans in Owen Sound, if they want to see the first game, better move.
Looking forward to having them here in Mississauga.
And there'll be a pile of them here, let me tell you. What great fans they've got.
Yeah, no, it's a great rink up there as well. Spent a lot of time up there a few years ago for the Ontario Tankard with Rogers Television, and got to know a lot of people in the area, certainly the arena very well. And it's a great spot for the Ontario Hockey League Championship, the Rogers Cup, and we're glad to have the fans come down to Mississauga as Corrente tries to keep it in. Fritch is clear on the stick of Shug, but he's almost double-teamed as soon as he got the puck. Puts it deep for Devontae Smith-Pelly. He, too. There you see two attack players right away on the puck carrier. D'Orazio's got some room because of that. Look out. Smith-Pelly took that one high, and he's going to the bench. Thank goodness it's under his own steam, and there's nothing coming from anywhere.
Don't know where that hit him, Dan. It hit him in the upper body for sure, and it looks like he's shaking off. Might have been the shoulder.
Yeah. Thank goodness that wasn't Adam's apple collarbone area. That was dangerous. Here's Bureau along the board. Shaw trying to shove him out of the way. 8 minutes and 5 seconds to go in a 1-1 game here. Opening period. Cameron Brace tied up at the line. The Majors have the puck back again. Stretch pass, Bureau. Right wing, tried to drop it back. Transition now, Majors changing up the attack. Brace on the right wing, but very quickly, Percy is there. Lost his stick, centering pass by everybody. Bureau just flips the puck high and backing up. Gilbert, a little bit of trouble with it, can't clear. Fleming to open ice. And Mayer lost his stick, racing in, knocked out of his hands by Matt Petgrave. Matt didn't reach for it, so no interference call on the play. And now it's J.P. Anderson looking to his right, hugging the post, and he'll cover up, take no chances. Nice shift by Matt Petgrave, the Brampton native, drawing some attention after the whistle, but speedy number 22 causing some problems.
And he caused some problems against the Windsor Spitfires with his first hat trick of the season, four-point game in the closeout game for the Owen Sound Attack. They won that one 10-4. There we look at Devontae Smith-Pelly at the Majors bench, still trying to shake that puck. Maybe we're going to pick it up here, perhaps.
Boy, D'Orazio stepped into this, too.
Yeah, he did. Well, it's hard to tell from there. Might have been just the chest area. You know, that shot so hard, it hurts you anywhere. Be a nice bruise there tomorrow, I would imagine, but looks like Devo's okay.
Blacker off the faceoff, comes down the wall, working the corner along with Verdnikoff. And behind the net, it's Jamel Smith. Shot goes off the behind of Smith and out to center ice. Left wing is Jamie Wise with a shoot-in. Stager behind the net. Cutting, quick pass ahead, just like Mississauga. These teams very similar in a number of aspects with the way they break out of their own end. They don't mess around. And you see a lot of back and forth in this series. Jamie Wise with a hit. Knocks Smith off the puck, frees it up for Canton. The veteran's going to shoot it in and go after it himself. Shots 5-4 in favor of the Majors. 1-1 game. Each team with a power play goal as their opponents serve the penalty for interference. Kitson with a nice steal. Maxim Kitson wires it high. What a playoff he's had for St. Mike's. Mississauga Major really settling in since he came over after the World Junior Hockey Championships, where he was a star for Team Russia. Unfortunately for Canadian fans and head coach Dave Cameron. Now happy to see him in a groove. Here's McNardy looking for his second, and that one stopped by Anderson. Gets it back again, top of the circle. Feed down low, tipped away from Maidens. Puck behind the net. McNardy in his skates can't find it. Semich comes down the wall, plays behind the goal. Maidens, head up. McNardy behind the net. Nice possession here by Owen Sound. Semich again looking for the tip in front, and Helis was going to the net. The attack, keep it coming. Helis behind the net. No wraparound. Canton's there. Loose puck. Anderson with the save. And 5:28 to go on the first. And McNardy and the attack putting on the pressure.
Man in the middle is Justin Shug, number four. And what an opportunity he's got to make a little history. Only a handful of players, I think it's maybe half a dozen players, have won three Memorial Cups in their career. And then if you factor into it, if Justin Shug should be so fortunate this year, it'll be three in a row. Because he won two in Windsor back-to-back, he's got a chance to do just that. And Dan, I remember Alicia Warner was talking to him before the season, him and Mark Canton. She asked them both what was more fun, the OHL Championship or the Memorial Cup. Guess what they said? The OHL Championship.
I'm guessing to win your own league championship.
Absolutely. No disrespect, Memorial Cup is a fabulous event, but anybody who's suggesting, well, these teams are going to the Memorial Cup anyway, so what? There's a league title on the line here.
Yeah, well, the Mem Cup's a bit of a one-off. You see a couple teams you don't see all year, so there's a couple of excuses written into the books. Right here, there are none, even though these two teams only faced each other twice in the regular season. Majors won both of those affairs, but that doesn't matter tonight, as you can tell, as the Owen Sound Attack. They are leading in possession 5-on-5 so far in this game. And Fleming backing up with Wilson watching.
And Wednesday, May 25th, these teams will meet again at the Hershey Center. We don't know how long this series will go, but that game and tickets are available as well at the Memorial Cup here in the Hershey Center.
Well, if this first 15 minutes plus is any indication, I think we're in for a good 6 or 7 gamer, no doubt about it, between these two teams. No one's going anywhere easily. Corey Bureau. Right wing shoot in from center ice. Stager out to play it. Took a look at his pal Shemich, but decided to go the other way. Shemich gets it anyway. Up at center ice. Nice little dish off the line, but offside as it's touched by Mike Halmel, Waterloo native.
Well, Riley Brace with some words for a couple of attack players as they go off. The fine line between aggression and being undisciplined is something both teams, of course, want to walk. And we've had a couple of interference penalties, and that's it so far. And Dave Cranmer preaches that all the time. He wants you to play with an edge, but don't go over the edge. Mark Reeds is the same. And what a job Mark Reeds has done with the Owen Sound attack. This team missed the playoffs last year. You find me one OHL preseason prediction that said the Owen Sound attack would be in the OHL final this year. You find it and you send it to me, and I won't be hanging around the email box waiting for it, because nobody picked this team to go this far. Tremendous accomplishment.
Stager plays a puck into harm's way, and the Majors keep it deep. Mayer, who had himself a great start to these playoffs, he was on fire for St. Mike's. Out there along with Jamie Wise. Here's a pass in the slot, and Kramarosa's shot doesn't get through. Canton takes a look. Brace over his shoulder, so a quick backhand pass. Wise tip. Okay, says the linesman. And Wise will get after it against Kevin Cunning. Bracebridge native, and then a penalty on the play, and there's the evidence on the ice for the slash. And Jamie Wise knows he's been not so wise on that play. Sometimes those sticks, though, are so fragile or even already broken sometimes. You don't have to touch it a whole lot.
No, you don't, but Wise touched it enough to draw the penalty, and boy, the stick fell apart after the slash.
It fell apart after. It didn't, yeah. It didn't even hit that area of the stick.
Yeah.
That's my point. Sometimes those things are fragile. You just give them a nudge and it jars the bottom end loose.
So another power play, Owen Sound. They're one for one, as are the Majors.
Look out, Fleming knocks it off. Not that you and I would know much about these sticks. We don't afford the...
I wouldn't pay that kind of money.
We're still using the wooden
stick.
Sherwoods and whatever else they've got on the market.
And it'll last a lot longer, too.
Yeah. They'll face it off again to the left of J.P. Anderson, who so far has faced 8 shots. One has gotten by number 34. You see Jamie Wise in the box for the Majors. Former Peterborough Pete, who has settled in nicely here in Mississauga since joining the team. Dave Cameron brought him over, gave him a chance. And really from game number one that Jamie Wise played as a Major, save for right here, right now, he's been in the good books of Dave Cameron. And I don't think once Dave sees a replay on that penalty, he'll really fault his forward. 1:43 left in this power play for Owen Sound. Hishon takes a look up top. He's got options in Blacker and Stanish. Hishon gets a return pass. Stanish goes down to the far post. Now pops back up top. Hishon, Blocker, save Anderson. Shug looking to clear. Gets it to the corner. Fleming can't get his stick on it. And then the pass back goes by everybody. And Stager comes way out to play it. Pass to center ice, Hishon. Under pressure right away from D'Souza. A nice puck movement now for Blacker, who carries the puck across the line. Patience with it now with 1:05 to go on the power play. 1-1 game, first period of the Rogers Cup, the OHL Championship. Dan Dunleavy, Roger Lajoie, Alicia Warner, and the rest of the Rogers family. Glad you could be with us for this championship series. Nice little fake by Hishon. Holds onto it, and then I think Anderson might have got a piece of that with the glove. 45 seconds remain of this power play. Here with a shot, and that one went wide. Wilson in a pretty good spot when he let that one go. Stanish at the point. This power play unit's been out there for the entire portion of this power play. There they go to the bench on a change now.
And a good penalty kill so far here for the Majors. And this is what the Majors have done so well during the postseason. Their penalty kill was 11th or 12th, and 12th in the regular season. First most of the postseason.
Shaw carries. Shemich back at the point. Settles it. Cross ice with Petgrave. Top of the circle. No shot. Shaw's back pass by everybody. Kramarosa will not get to the puck, but boy, there was a moment you thought maybe. Jamie Wise out of the box. Last minute of play here in the opening period. D'Arazio. Away from McNardy. Brace. A little slow in getting that puck, but the Majors get there and chance now to clear it off the glass and out to center ice. Brace after it. Look out on the bench of the Owen Sound attack. Coach will pick it up, put it back onto the ice.
And they'll continue play, so a good penalty kill. Shots are 10-5 for Owen Sound here. And you mentioned, Dan, the attack when it's been 5-on-5 have been pretty impressive and have certainly have more than held their own. In fact, perhaps carried the play a little bit here from the Majors. 46.7 seconds left in this opening period. Both teams have a power play goal. McNardy at 6-11, Smith-Pelly at 3-54. Pretty good first period.
Left wing pass, Helis gets the puck deep, pass back to the point intended there for Maidens. Nice idea, but the Majors break it up. Well read, Kitson at center ice, can't handle the pass. Canton and Fleming, defense pair out there for the Majors right now. Pass to the blue line, Smith-Pelly. And Helis battle for the puck, Majors keep it in. Here's Kitson, rolling puck. Waits for traffic to get to the net. Also finds some space. He's got the space now. Tries to turn it down low. Now a possible 3-on-2 with 8 seconds to go. But the attack can't manufacture the attack. And with 4 seconds to go, Canton takes a look up. The veteran will play that puck to the area with least amount of harm possible. And we have a 1-1 score after 20 minutes in game one of our Rogers OHL championship.
Well, it's the number one team in points in the OHL versus the number two team. The Majors are 12-1 in the playoffs. Owen Sound is 12-3. So on paper, it's a pretty even matchup. And I tell you what, after one period, it doesn't get more even than this. Owen Sound out shooting Mississauga 10-5. But after 20 minutes, we're tied 1-1. This is the OHL championship series on Rogers TV. Let's head down to the panel and get the thoughts led by Ben Ennis.
Thank you very much, Rog, Ben Ennis, Peter Curtis, and Matt Scooby here atop of the Hershey Center with the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors Owen Sound attack all tied up at ones. And I talked before this game off the top of this broadcast that these are the two best teams, at least during the regular season, in the OHL. Should be a great series, judging by the first 20 minutes of game one. It's living up to expectations.
Well, the goalies haven't had a lot of shots on goal, but there's been a lot of action in front of both goaltenders. The idea being, hey, you got two of the best goalies in the league. We got to get some traffic in front of them.
That was Owen Sound's thing. We kind of watched it for a couple of points there. Owen Sound had two guys in front of J.P. Anderson at a couple of points. Both power plays clicking, you know, maybe not the Owen Sound one there at the end of that period, but given two opportunities, both teams capitalized on the first power play opportunity. So going to be a lot of scoring, going to be a fair amount of offense. Again, there also went about 6 minutes without a shot in that first period. So a little bit of neutral zone plays. These teams kind of feel each other out. Remember, they only played two games against each other going back in November, so it's kind of a reacquaintance period for these two teams.
Yeah, a couple of power play goals, you guys mentioned it. Devontae Smith-Pelly opening up the scoring for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors on the power play. And it was Robbie McNardy with his 10th power play goal of the postseason for the Owen Sound attack. That is good for the team lead for the attack. Another member, key member of that Owen Sound attack team, Matt Petgrave, joining Alicia Warner right now.
Guys, Matt Petgrave with me at the Owen Sound attack. They scored an early one on the power play, but you guys responded with a power play goal of your own. What are your thoughts on the first 20?
The first 10 minutes was kind of feeling out each other's teams. We haven't played each other since November, so trying to get used to each other's space out there. And I think it was a little bit cheesy penalty on the first one, but like we capitalized on our power play, and that's all that matters right now.
You had one of possibly the best games of your OHL career when you closed out against Windsor with a four-point night and a hat trick. Do you carry that momentum into this series against Mississauga, or do you start fresh?
Oh, you got to start fresh with a new series. Can't be too worried about the past, but you obviously carry that confidence into a big game like this.
A lot of people talk about the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, that they're hosting Memorial Cup here in Mississauga, but you're from Brampton.
Yeah.
So this must be pretty neat for you to be playing in an OHL final and a Memorial Cup so close to home.
Yeah, it definitely is. I got a lot of fans up there in the stands right now coming to watch me play, and definitely feels like I'm playing on at home right now.
Finally, your thoughts for the final 40 minutes on how to stay up on these guys and pick up a win on the road.
We just got to keep forechecking. We have a good, fast team, and I don't think they can compete with that.
We've got Matt Petgrave here with us in the first intermission. Score is tied at 1-1. After the break, we'll have game notes for you here. OHL Hockey on Rogers TV.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Looking to get your sports fix? Join our panel each week for RTV Sports Wrap.
As we dive into sports topics with in-depth discussion, predictions, and opinions.
Local, provincial, national, world sports. We cover it all.
Everything you want to know that is happening in the world of sports.
Sports and more sports. It's all right here on RTV Sports Wrap, only on Rogers TV.
Stand up stronger. I got the power, gonna raise it up. So high, we're shining brighter. We got the power, gonna raise it up. We got the power, gonna raise it up.
Step right up, the show is about to begin.
By age 40.
By age 40, about 50% of the population will have
or have had a mental illness.
Approximately 8% of adults
will experience major depression
at some time in their lives.
Once depression is recognized,
help can make a difference.
Help can make a difference for over 80% of people who are affected,
allowing them to get back to their regular activities.
Rogers TV is a proud community partner in supporting Mental Health Week.
Hashtag get real about how you feel.
When it comes time to be on the ice, that's the only thing on your mind, and that's when you're on the ice in practice, you're trying to get better.
Welcome back, and just a heads up, the OHL draft does come up this weekend, Saturday, May 7th. For all the details, head to OntarioHockeyLeague.com to check out how they are going to be covering it online. Welcome back upstairs into the Hershey Center. Ben Ennis, Peter Curtis, Matt Scooby going to break down this first period of action with the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors all tied up at ones with the Owen Sound Attack in game one of the OHL Championship Series. And so far, gentlemen, special teams has been the story with both goals coming on the power play. Majors come into this game with the best penalty killing unit in the playoffs, clicking at over 90%. They get the goal on the power play, but then give up a goal shorthanded with Rob Flick in the box for interference. But Devontae Smith-Pelly scores on the power play to give the Majors the lead. What did you guys see on both the power play and the penalty kill for both teams?
Well, with Mississauga, I know Smith-Pelly, instead of being in front of the net, actually scored from the high slot. Here's a guy that scores most of his goals, 2 feet away from the net? He scored from almost 5 feet away, so it's a different strategy, and perhaps Owen Sound's going to have to adjust and come and follow him into the high slot area, because it looked for a split second he didn't want to go to the front of the net and take some abuse in this game.
I kind of think that's just kind of changing it up for Dave Cameron and his power play squad. On the other side, in Owen Sound, they just had a good passing play. The Majors forwards kind of got caught, and they were able to make a nice passing play between Halmo and Shaw, and then it was McNarty finishing it off. Their power play, again, impressed me because they have a player, again, in front of J.P. Anderson at all times. This is what we haven't seen throughout the course of the playoffs so far, is that the teams have kind of been rotating out, not getting Anderson space too much, but for the entirety of that Owen Sound power play, when they got the chance to set up, there was a player standing in front of the net, something they need to continue to do.
Yeah, Michael Halmo with an absolutely spectacular pass in front to Robbie McNarty, who put home his 10th of the postseason already in this, the 16th game now for the Owen Sound Attack in the playoffs. This is the only game going on right now, obviously, but there is other action around the CHL. Let's throw it upstairs to Brad and Will with that.
Thanks, Ben. Yeah, a lot of action around the country, and of course, one particular game we're keeping an eye on. A little Q&A so we can set everything up for the rest of the country from a major junior standpoint. I'm going to be the Q. You, Will, are going to be the A.
Okay, let's
you
do this.
You good with that? First of all, Mississauga, they are in the Memorial Cup.
That's correct.
Okay. Right or wrong, Owen Sound in the Memorial Cup.
That is absolutely correct.
Okay. I have my abacus. That means there's two spots available after those two teams. Yeah. Let's start in Quebec. One spot for a team in Quebec. What's the situation out there?
Yes, of course, the Quebec champion will be coming here to Mississauga to play the opening game of the Memorial Cup against Mississauga on May the 20th. And let's see how that shapes up, shall we? Well, the St. John Sea Dogs are awaiting their opponent in the final, because right now, as we speak, the final game, game seven of the other semifinal, is going on right now between the Gatineau Olympiques and the Quebec Ramparts. And Gatineau, we're down.
Early lead. Early lead tonight.
That's right. They're up 2-0 after the first period. Gatineau came back from down three games to one to force this seventh game. And apparently it's been two soft goals on Quebec to give Gatineau the lead in game seven. So soft goaltending on Patrick Roy's team might be their undoing in game seven.
So there you have it. We're keeping an eye on that. The winner of that will play St. John. Like you said, that series starts on Thursday. Starting on Friday, Portland and Kootenay in the WHL. We'll have full preview later on to see what's going to happen in that series, because Kootenay's red hot and Portland is the number one seed. So that's our situation from across Canada. We'll keep you updated on Quebec and have a preview of other things later on. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, guys. Almost ready here for the second period of play, but I want to talk about one more storyline before we get underway for period two between the Majors and Attack, and that is Joey Hish and Garrett Wilson, Jesse Blacker joining J.P. Anderson as three snubs that did not make the Canadian junior team, of course, head coached by Dave Cameron. Maybe a little bit of revenge on their minds.
I don't know if it's revenge or just the fact that they want to show everyone you got it kind of right. You made it to the gold medal game, but you didn't get it quite right because you didn't have us on the team.
Don't forget about J.P. Anderson as well, who also got cut from the team. Dave Cameron said he flat out wasn't good enough, but that's it.
Well, we'll have to see how it pans out. Second period coming up. Are we clear?
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
It's hard to believe it's been 10 years since the Owen Sound Attack shocked the junior hockey world by winning the Ontario Hockey League Championship. But get ready to relive that moment on Rogers TV. Join me, Manny Pava, as I host a special edition of Attack Wrap with members of that 2011 championship team. It will air after the rebroadcast of all seven games of the 2011 OHL Final from May 9th to 15th.
In any given year...
In any given year, one in five people in Canada...
One in five people in Canada...
will personally experience a mental health problem or illness.
By age 40... about 50% of the population
will have or have had a mental illness.
Rogers TV is a proud community partner
in supporting Mental Health Week.
Hashtag get real
about how you feel.
Hashtag get real about how you feel.
Hi, I'm David Sherman, host of Politically Speaking. Join me for my next show, and my guests will be the Blue Water District Roman Catholic School Board on Politically Speaking on Rogers TV.
Get sued for doing the same thing my family's been doing for hundreds of years.
We're going to lose the farm.
We're going to the Supreme Court.
If you win, no farmer could ever be sued for saving his seeds again.
The target has superhuman abilities.
I think it's an invitation to fight for something known as Mortal Kombat.
Kill them.
A province-wide stay-at-home order is currently in effect. Limit trips outside the home. Remain in your local community. And work from home if you are able. Visit the province's website for more information.
He was fine and went on his next shift. Majors will need him. He got the first goal of this game on the power play at 3:54 to make it 1-0. And then the tying goal from Robbie McNardy. At 6:11, also a power play marker, beat J.P. Anderson. Dan Dunleavy upstairs with Roger Lajoie.
Good first period of play, especially for the visitors. They outshot the Majors 10-5. And we talked about the similarities between these two teams and how their mindsets are the same, I guess is the best way to phrase it. fundamentally sound, well coached, good goaltending. We saw a lot of all of that in period number one. Let's see what the rest of this game's got in store for us.
Well, and interesting comments made by our intermission guest, and Petgrave, mentioning that he felt that the speed of the Owen Sound attack is something the Majors cannot handle. And we have that not really being an issue right now, because it's the attack that will have to kill off a Majors power play. Check from behind into the boards. We'll see what is officially called. Boarding is the call.
And there it is. Joey Hishon just gets into Percy and knocks him down. Percy takes the hit. Referee saw it. Made the call 18 seconds in. So Mississauga, one for one on the power play. The attack, one for two. See if the Majors can keep that perfect night going.
Casey Cizikas has Canton up top. Canton cross ice, working this power play with Percy. Shug and Smith-Pelly out there for Mississauga as well. Looking to take a lead here on the power play. 1:45 remaining in it. Smith-Pelly tripped up. Stick into the skate. You can tell the way a player goes down if it was a stick in the skate or he stepped on a stick. Casey Cizikas cross ice. Shug can't settle it down. Percy up top. It's almost as if the rink is holding its breath here with every power play. You can tell it's a championship series. There's a chance in front. Percy bouncing puck. Cizikas can't knock it down. 1:14 remaining in the power play. Shug ahead of Garrett Wilson. Cizikas at the dot, takes a look up top. Smith-Pelly bouncing puck, and Percy can't get the shot away. Majors have to regroup back at center ice. He'll change it up. Cizikas and Percy go to the bench.
A lot of passes by the Majors, but nobody in front of the net. Now Smith-Pelly trying to get in front.
Stager hugging that post as Shug plays it back to the point. Fleming blocked it with his skate, keeps the puck moving on the wall. D'Orazio's come down from the point. He's in front of the net. There he is with a shot, the rebound. Stager stops them both. Keeps it 1-1. 29 seconds left in the power play.
Huge saves for Stager as D'Orazio snuck in, and Stager stuck the pad across. Nice athleticism, almost doing the splits there, and not one but two big saves.
Majors back in their own end with Fleming. Pressure from McNardy, the goal scorer. 10 seconds to go in the Mississauga power play. Rob Flick out there with Mayer and Maxim Kitson. And that'll do it for the power play. The attack get the job done. Their best penalty killer, Stager, on that occasion.
Two big saves by Stager, and power special teams so important. Now both teams even there, too, one for two.
Well, Stager and J.P. Anderson came into this series with identical save percentages, so the matchup between these two teams couldn't get much tighter. Here's Hishon now, out of the box. Nice pass going to the net. Unable to tip it home was Andrew Fritsch, the Bradford native. And the Majors clear the puck out to center ice. Right back in by Keevan Cutting. J.P. Anderson will leave it there. Majors finish up a line change with now 3 minutes gone here in period number two of a 1-1 game. Schoenmakers will leave it for Bureau. Schoenmakers behind the net. Tries a wraparound brace in front. Chance to transition now for the attack. Garrett Wilson leads the rush on the right wing. Tip wide of the goal by Hishon. Centered in front. Fired just wide. Wilson on the doorstep. Great chance for Owen Sound. The Majors clear the puck to center ice. Cutting backing up off the glass. Over top of Schoenmakers. Bureau just tips it deep. He'll head to the Mississauga bench and finish up the changes. Schoenmakers tries to keep the puck deep. He can't. Owen Sound so quick at getting out of their own end. Hishon will go to the bench as well. The shoot in on Anderson. Anderson seeing Cameron Brace coming down, holds it for a faceoff with 16:18 to go in the second.
Well, you mentioned getting out of the zone is something the Majors do, and Owen Sound doing it just as well. And here's the big save by Stager. Look at D'Orazio, perfectly positioned, and especially that first shot. Got to get it a little higher. Of course, D'Orazio, a defenseman, he's just pinching in there and wanting to get that puck out there as quickly as possible. But Stager equal to the task.
Got to be Vinny LeCavalier there with the overtime goal. Get that puck up on the roof when you're that close. Easier said than done.
Well, a little difference between Vinny LeCavalier and Michael D'Orazio and the goal scoring ability.
I said don't be him.
But no question, you're right, Dan. You get that puck up another inch, and it doesn't matter how far along that pad is.
Stannis shot from the point, gloved down by Anderson, and Anderson will take no chances. A little bit of a knock there from Mike Halmo. It's the championship round, and the linesmen come in and have a word with Halmo and say next time maybe you should just skate by and not try to initiate contact. Shaw will take the faceoff for the attack. Quick shot off the draw, and Anderson again makes the stop.
You know, you look for the usual hints as to who might eventually take control of a series, and both these teams are so similar. You know, Dan, they're great when they get the first goal of the game, but both teams and the majors have shown it, as another puck goes into the mesh, shown it in the postseason, their ability to bounce back after being behind. They were down 3-0 to Sudbury in game four of the second round, in the third period, 9 minutes into the third period, came back and won that. We're down against the Niagara Ice Dogs 2-0 in game three of the Eastern Conference Final. Won that. Owen Sound was down to London, remember, in the first series, 2-1, never mind being down to game. So both teams are resilient. So those traditional stats you look at, first goal or trends or momentum, you kind of have to push aside when you get to these two teams.
Shaw giving chase around the majors net. Puck comes in front, and Anderson will hold that one again. And again, more traffic skating by the Mississauga netminder, and the referees are there to perhaps have a word with the boys.
Well, J.P. Anderson doesn't want to take any chances. He smothered the puck numerous times. You see Jordan Mayer, who's had a pretty good playoff for the majors. Mayer's got that penchant for scoring big goals this postseason. Had a big two-goal game in the majors' second-round win.
Face off to the left of Anderson. Jugerly on the draw for the attack. Puck deep in the major zone. Now a chance for Shug. And Ben Pass looking for Smith-Pelly. And trying to get that one on the stick of Cizikas. Smith-Pelly's got his second of the game. 2-1 St. Mike's. Puck got lost in the skates of Blacker. And Casey Cizikas took advantage of that. And then Smith-Pelly said thank you very much.
Talk about putting it up high. Watch how high up Smith-Pelly goes, just under the goalpost. Great, great goal scorer's goal. If that puck is even an inch lower, Stager probably gets it with his glove just over the top. Watch how high up that shot is by Smith-Pelly. Great camera angle from up high there. 4:27, Devontae Smith-Pelly with his second of the night. And the majors, look at that smile, 2-1 lead.
Well, you get to this portion of this tournament, and that's where those goals will come from. Special teams, and there you see a very good defenseman in Jesse Blacker. Just one brief hiccup, can't get the puck out of his skates. And, you know, the majors defenseman will suffer the same fate against this very speedy Owen Sound team. Keyless trying to tip it in the major zone, but St. Mike's turn it the other way. Rob Flick snaps one on, and Stager took a look after he gloved it down, and then Kitson's given a couple of shots, gives a couple back.
Well, Maxim Kitson has certainly elevated his game in the last, I'd say two rounds of the playoffs. Took a while to get acclimatized to the country, of course, after coming over, and you mentioned Dan playing in the World Junior Hockey Championship, Los Angeles Kings draft pick. Very highly regarded and sought after player. Dave Cameron coached against him at the World Junior Championship, and I'm sure never forgave Maxim for his part in that third period comeback in the gold medal game.
He just can't forget.
Yeah, I don't even think he's forgiven. But Kitson was good. Right. Kitson was good then, and he's been very good recently.
He's getting into a real stick match here with Keevan Cutting. They're going back and forth with one another. Referees, to this point, not really having much to say about it. Stager, though, he was sharp off that draw. Quick shot. Rob Flick will line it up again against Joey Hishon. Hishon wins it this time, but Kitson jumps on the bouncing puck, turns off the boards. Still has it in his skates, can't get the shot away. 6'2", 185, Maxim Kitson. So he's certainly got the frame to shield the puck, and that's an offside against Mississauga.
He does, and he does a great job at using that long stick as well to keep the puck away from defenders. It's one of the strengths of his play. As we look at Stuart Percy, one of the anchors of this major's defense. We talk about the majors rolling four lines all the time for Dave Cameron.
he likes to roll his sixth defenseman all the time too and get everybody involved. But first, you're going to be a high draft pick in the NHL draft. And hey, good luck to all the young men who are watching tonight, whose names will be called Saturday in the OHL draft. It's almost lost because it happens during the OHL final, but the fresh young group of players.
Here's Cizikas with a chance. Puck bounces in front, still loose, so the attack come away with it.
And those young men will join this league Saturday morning via the internet.
Cizikas with a hit on Berdnikoff as he was trying to come up the ice. Percy. And he's out there along with another pretty good defenseman in Fleming, draft pick of the Washington Capitals, and it's no surprise. It's Cizikas with another shot. No surprise how good Percy has become so soon, playing with a player as consistent as Fleming. Here's another chance for Smith-Pelly. Loose puck out behind Stager. Can't find it. All he does is squeeze the pads and hope, and he keeps it out.
Boy, Smith-Pelly has got the mojo going tonight. He's got two goals, and he found a little bit of room on that five hole on that shot by Stager, and Stager just was a little wishing and praying. Let's watch this play develop. Nice work by Shug to get it over. Smith-Pelly snapshot, and where's that puck? It squirts loose and kept back into the Owen Sound goaltender. DSP is doing it tonight for the Majors, almost at his third goal of the game.
Credit Shemitz with that save as he tucked the puck in under his goaltender. Now Schoenmakers and Gilbert battle behind the net. Comes up the near wall for D'Orazio. Keeps it deep. Riley Brace. Majors picking up their pace a little bit here in the second period. And I think Matt Petgrave, when he made that comment, St. Mike's would not be able to keep up with their speed. The Majors were a little slow-footed in that opening period, but they've got the jump now as Riley Brace works with Corey Bureau and Schoenmakers. And now it's Owen Sound having trouble getting going. Ray shielding that puck, curls out of the corner. Lost it. And back comes Owen Sound. 13:20 to go, and offside. Little hop and skip in the jump there of Andrew Shaw. Over on the right wing.
Well, much better second period so far for the Majors. We're 6 minutes and 41 seconds into it, Dan, and you're right. And listen, Petgrave has got a lot of confidence in his team, and Mark Reed's team does have a lot of speed. But if it comes down to a battle of speed, conditioning, rolling the forward lines, as good as Owen Sound is, there's a slight advantage in this series to Mississauga, with all due respect to him and the attack. Owen Sound can match the Majors in a lot of ways, but so can the Majors to Owen Sound. A lot of speed in Mississauga, too.
Broken stick opens up some ice as Jamie Wise has to go back to the bench, and a penalty as a result. It's amazing how something seemingly so harmless happens in one area of the game, but it just creates a domino effect. And because Wise lost his stick, broken on the play, not good to see Blacker go off like this on the limp, but the way he is limping, I'd hazard a guess he's just walking that one off. But that started a chain of events that sees Canton go to the penalty box because that space opened up and the Majors got in a bit of a panic.
Got in a panic and had to felt he had to trip the man up to stop it because Majors player was back getting a stick because the stick had snapped. And it's an easy call. Canton gets the hip out.
So therein lies the question, and in that situation with the puck in your own zone, Jamie Wise, is he better to stay in his own end and play without the stick? Took himself right out of the play, goes to the bench with the play still in his own end, basically giving the team a power play there for about 5 seconds.
I would find that any time the puck's in your own end.
Stick around.
Yes. Thank you.
Eric Wilson back to the point. So the power play goes to work here for the attack. Stanish, Shemitz, and the bouncing puck in the slot. Majors clear. Shemitz will go back after it. Toronto native decides to leave it. Stanis will start it with a pass up through the center. Hamel can't find it in his skates. Stanis following up. Everybody's onside. Hishin deep in the Major zone as the puck comes on the near wall. Fritsch plays it up top. Here's a chance. Anderson with a save, and the rebound is shoveled wide. Bouncing puck to the dot. Glove down and fired wide to the mark again. 105 remaining in the power play. Chance now for D'Souza, and he decides not to try and split the D, but rather hold on to the puck for a moment and then put it deep.
There's a veteran forward making a smart play because D'Souza might have got caught off ice if he hadn't. If he'd made that move, be cautious when you're killing the penalty.
Majors penalty number 22.
The attack trying the left wing this time. DeMello with a hit on Halmo as he tips it deep. D'Orazio there, along with Jamie Wise. And Majors clear that puck now with 35 seconds to go. Stager way out to play it. And he'll leave it for Jay Gilbert. Port Stanley, Ontario. Pass up through center. Now Petgrave on the left wing around Cizikas. Centering pass beyond everybody. Gilbert from the point, shot blocked, and that one being felt a little bit by Riley Brace. Hamel from behind the net, another interference call coming up. Got a lot of these going on, and it's going to be Petgrave to the penalty box. Majors. 9 seconds, sorry, Roger, remained in the Majors penalty.
Majors wanting to be careful there as Riley Brace skated over to Petgrave and said something, but when you got that penalty coming, discretion, the better part of valor. Canton standing in the penalty box wants to know, do you want me to go right to the bench or do you want me to
stay? Petgrave doesn't want to be on TV, I guess not.
Good communication by Canton there. He stood up, looked over the bench, said, look, 9 seconds in my penalty. What do you want? Want me to go to the bench? You want me to stay out? Because in 9 seconds, it's a Majors power play. I would suspect Canton, with the faceoff in Owen Sound territory, just hop right into the play here. And he will, because Fleming is playing up on the wing. Now maybe that means there'll be another forward out here. Let's see what Dave Cameron does.
Right now, not taking any chances 4-on-4, Roger, in case this happens. They lose the faceoff, and back the other way, it's Helus. Canton out of the box now, and there's your call. Forward for the defenseman as Kitson comes over the boards, leads the team in power play goals. And on the ice now with 1:42 to go on the man advantage. 2-1, Mississauga with the lead. Game one of this Rogers Championship Series. The final is underway at Hershey Center between these two Memorial Cup-bound teams. D'Orazio and Fleming. Capitals pick, slides it back up top. D'Orazio holds it, looks for space, not there. Fleming, good puck movement, but Owen Sound doing a good job at keeping play to the outside. Now Fleming moving away as Mayer trying to find some space. Kitson in the corner, battling down low with Stanis. Mayer comes up with it, gets it back again. Mayer kicks it back to a stick, and the pass down low doesn't work. Here's a shot that's fired wide of the mark. Fleming with 58 seconds to go on the power play. Back from D'Orazio. Bounces off the end of a stick, plays it down low. Gets a return pass. Majors looking for an opening here, and they're not seeing a whole lot. Blacker and Stanis down low. Attack doing a great job with their box out right now. 38 seconds to go. Majors trying to show some patience. Rob Flick snaps one on, and Stager makes the stop. And then more pushing and shoving on Maxim Kitson afterwards. Kitson claiming he took a slash in the ankles after.
Well, Kitson gets a lot of attention and now goes back and has another conversation with Hishin, as he didn't like the fact he felt he was hacked at, as you said. Majors throwing around here, maybe guilty of a little bit too cute here on the power play, and instead of just firing that puck towards the net and getting bodies in front, Maxim Kitson tried to get in front and grimaces as he took a couple of whacks. That's the price you pay, though. When everyone says go to the net, go to the net. You know why a lot of players don't want to go to the net? You're going to get slashed and hacked at. It's not fun now in front of the goalie.
Tell you, one of the little things, in just a moment, Casey Cizikas took care of business there with his own teammate. Majors power play with 25 seconds remaining, and now they're on the defensive as McNarty tips it outside the line and deep into Mississauga territory. Percy on the back end along with Canton as they try to manufacture something, Mississauga, with 13 to go on the power play as they gain the zone. Here's a chance. Smith Pelly's out front again, and Shug held onto it. Devontae with two already this evening. But as Kitson went to the bench, Casey Cizikas went over and had a word with him and probably told him the exact same thing you just said, Roger. Welcome to the championship. This is going to be happening all series long. You've got to let it go. This little 3-on-2 down low all of a sudden for the attack.
That was a beautiful play and a real dangerous shot there. Anderson had to make a good toe save. But you're right, Dan, you have to stay away from it. It's hard. But yeah, how many times you get whacked and slashed, you turn around and slash the player, who's getting the penalty?
That's right.
You are.
Well, and the other thing, too, is it's no secret. If you're Owen Sound, who do you want to throw off their game?
Players
eliminate
like
number
Kitson.
13 and just go hack and whack at him a little bit. Pretty sure that Kitson will probably give his fair share of taps as well as the series goes on. There aren't many innocent people on the ice when you get to this point in the playoffs. Riley Brace taking it wide, and Stager doing a good job again. Boy, they're almost mirror images, J.P. Anderson and Stager, when you see how they line up and cover these angles.
No question. Let's take a look at the goals from our game so far. 2-1 St. Mark's.
In the Owen Sound attack, had two of those goals go against them, one goal for them. 8:24 to go in the second period. 2-1, the Majors leading the Owen Sound attack. Dan Dunleavy, Roger Lajoie, Alicia Warner, our great crew here as well. Rogers TV in Durham, welcome me, especially everybody watching the OHL Action Pack.
I dare you to name everybody on the crew.
I can't. I'm sorry, there's human. And, of course, everybody watching on the OHL Action Pack throughout Ontario and the United States. OHL Final, one thing it does is kind of brings the OHL fraternity of Rogers stations together. So a special shout-out to all of the great crews that bring OHL hockey throughout the province, Dan, and so many great Rogers TV crew. And my buddies in Oshawa among them do such a fantastic job. We acknowledge them. And maybe your turn to do an OHL Final will be coming up 1 year, too, because we really appreciate this.
It has been many years in the making for this franchise and being enjoyed by all that are taking part in it, mostly the players, though. That's the story we tell, is the Majors now with Rob Flick again testing Stager, and Stager making it look so easy, and Rob Flick's not going to back down from Blacker, and that is a trade-off, I'm sure, one for one, that Dave Cameron would be all right with, getting number 12 off the ice.
And good to see Blacker back on the ice after he went off, of course, in some discomfort. As you said, Dan, it was probably just a hard shot or something and kicked it off. And their first shot, Flick delivers. Blacker doesn't like it. And then they do the pushing and shoving. Rob Flick has turned into a premier player in this league for the Majors. Watched him develop the last couple of seasons. Marty Williamson still has the best line I've heard to describe this Majors team. Four checking lines that can score.
Stager pad save and they attack with Maidens. McNarty quickly into Majors territory. Save made by Anderson. He gets over for the rebound as Maidens got the shot away. And I think we just saw the strength of the attack, and that is how quickly they can transition out of their end and manufacture an opportunity. The Majors may be four lines deeper than anybody else in the Ontario League, as we see now with their transition. And a rebound, what a stop. Stager robs D'Souza.
Boy, what a job by D'Souza to corral that puck off the big rebound, but Stager followed him right across, and that one was almost ticketed, but D'Souza, no chance there. Is great stop. Anderson makes a save and gets over to protect the post. Now back the other way, DeMello shot, look at the big rebound, and D'Souza got a lot on it, but Stager was there, a rebound. D'Souza could not get another clear shot at. Two big saves, both ends of the rink. Opens up a little bit here.
Well, and this might be one of those series that's low scoring, but you actually enjoy it, because I don't think it'll be for lack of opportunities. We're seeing early, and we've seen throughout these playoffs with these two goaltenders, Roger, that teams are going to get their chances once in a while. That certainly won't be necessarily any, you know, 52 save performances like we saw from a Tim Thomas in the NHL last night. But these guys will be kept busy, and they'll keep their teams in games.
Good defensive hockey doesn't mean a lack of scoring opportunities, Dan. You still need great goaltending, and when you've got great goaltending like this, one of the reasons these teams play so well defensively, they have so much confidence in their goalies. So you're absolutely right. Low scoring doesn't necessarily mean no action. We've had a couple of good chances in this period by both teams.
J.P. Anderson had a call-up with the San Jose Sharks, free agent signing. Undrafted, didn't play, but sat on the bench up in the Shark Tank. After not making Team Canada. Still went to see a game, though, in Buffalo at the World Junior Hockey Championships. Support his country and his coach, who at the time said he wasn't better than Mark Vicentin to represent his country. And that wasn't easy for Dave Cameron to tell his goaltender, but he knew he would be able to handle it and lead his team to where they are right now.
And Anderson, full credit to that.
Chance in front. Jamie Wise doing his hard work behind the net.
NHL fans will remember it's almost like when Pat Quinn yanked Curtis Joseph for Marty Brodeur in the Olympics. It's like you can't play favorites. Everyone says, well, how could you do that to your own goaltender? Because you're coaching Team Canada.
That's what Curtis Joseph said.
Well, that's Cujo didn't work out too well with Cujo, but no. JP Anderson's been a lot better about it.
Here's Shaw now, and he's being bumped off the puck, affords the Majors possession of the blue line. Casey Cizikas and Riley Brace battling, then Shaw gives Brace a shove, and Majors forward will go to the bench. Here's Shug throwing it in front of the goal, hoping for a deflection. 19-15 shots on net, and almost a transition for Cameron Brace, but a nice save by Percy. Now Shug in front, Cizikas! Oh, what a stop! Rebound, he scores! The captain puts the Majors up 3-1 here in the second with 6 minutes to go.
Oh, there's some great second effort from the captain there, Casey Cizikas, after Stager robbed him on the first opportunity, but Cizikas would not be denied. Nice play by Shug. Look at the first shot. Whacking, and that puck comes loose, and finally Cizikas pops it home on the third chance. Three times he got a whack at that puck as it lay there, and Cizikas gets it done. Fifth goal of the playoffs, and the Majors have a two-goal lead.
Official over at the timekeeper's bench just to make sure everything was good with the goal. Now they get the mention that it is. And Casey Cizikas with his fourth goal here in the postseason. And now Owen Sound will run into that same old style of play. The Majors won't change anything here. Up by two, and the attack know that. They are a well-coached hockey team that are certainly prepared for the series, but sometimes it doesn't matter how prepared you are for this, you just have to find a way around it.
Well, that's it. And you know, Dave Cameron is one of his mantras has always been, it's not about the other team, it's about us. We prepare our team. And people with the first two rounds of the playoff, Dan, saw the Majors beat Belleville four straight with a lot of close games, beat Sudbury four straight with several close games. And people said, well, wait till they play the better teams, it's going to be different. No, it's not. It's the same thing all the time. And whether that's good enough to win an OHL championship, we'll find out in the next 12 days or so. But the Majors play the same all the time, and that's a key to this team's success. 3-1 or Owen Sound or Sudbury, Belleville, or 5-0.
Here's a chance, scores! They're starting to pour it on now. D'Souza makes it 4-1.
Once again, lots of traffic in front of the net and great pressure and never say die attitude. And the Mississauga boy, who's going to play in the Memorial Cup in his hometown, does the finish job here in front. Watch D'Souza dig it out, backhand, quick shot, and Johnny on the spot was flicked with the pass. Quick pass in front, and D'Souza, ooh, five-hole there. Five-holer between the post, hard to tell. Watch it again. There was a lot of white space to shoot at.
And you know where all that started? Maxim Kitson, the puck just inside the Majors' blue line here on the near boards, came to Maxim Kitson. Here's almost a turnover by the Majors.
Boy, DiRaggio blew a tire there in the worst possible time, but Majors got away with it.
I want to get to that point on Kitson because, again, it's little things. Kitson, instead of carrying the puck up the ice, Roger, he did what the Majors do. He just tipped it outside the blue line, and the next player came forward. That started the rush up the ice. Kitson hangs on to the puck. You know, perhaps it's a different outcome as far as getting the puck into Owen Sound territory.
Great point. Move it up quickly. That's a transition. We talk about a speedy transition game. That's how you keep the puck moving down the ice quickly.
And being unselfish with the puck. Just get it outside the line, then take care of business from there. And both teams, as we've seen tonight, Owen Sound do the same thing. That's the modus operandi. Once that puck is outside your own end of the ice, then you can start going to work as an icing call comes up here with 4:25 to go in the second period. The Majors have opened this one up here in game one.
And two goals, those last two goals, just 43 seconds apart by Cizikas and D'Souza. And three goals in 10 minutes here in this second period.
Mark Reed still encouraging his team.
Well, as you mentioned, the attack faced a pretty good Windsor Hockey Club, and Owen Sound used to bouncing back as well. Penalty coming up against the Majors. That'll open the door a little bit here to get it potentially down to a 4-2 hockey game. But right now, with the goaltender going to the bench, Majors get the puck back again, and there's the call. 4 minutes even to go here in period at number two, and a three-goal lead for Mississauga, but the penalty box now occupied by the captain, Casey Cizikas.
So a chance for Owen Sound. They're 1-for-2 in the power play. Scott Stager, I think, would like to have that last goal back, as didn't really protect the net as well as he could have. Now the Owen Sound attack after a tough stretch here with an opportunity on the power play. As I said, 1-for-2. Cizika sits for holding, 16 minutes even.
And McNardy, their power play goal scorer leader, is on the bench to start this attack power play. Won't matter right now as Jamie Wise gets the puck deep. Fleming now will back up his Hishing. Pass rink wide off of Blacker, who'll give chase. Blacker with a bit of a hack there on Percy. Puck tip just outside the line. Backhand by Fritsch doesn't get deep. Majors Corey Bureau. That's it to the Owen Sound line. Now Hishon. Little saucer pass inside the blue line. Now a rolling puck to Souza. Stager, and Stager gets there ahead of the Majors forward, who's got 1:15 to kill on this attack power play that so far has not been able to set up at all. Hishon on the boards. Garrett Wilson can't get it to the front of the net. Wilson trying to come out of the corner. Majors keeping that puck away from the danger area. Now Pecrae with a chance here. Takes the pass back again. Wilson. There's a chance and a snapshot by Joey Hishon. Misses the mark. JP might have got a piece of it. Hishon keeps the puck in the zone. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Hishon's going off on a change. And the Majors now with two players racing after the loose puck. It's a 2-on-1 shorthanded for Mississauga. Stopped by Stager. Canton with a chance.
Well, Canton was shooting all the way there at the tail end of that power play while still 29 seconds left in it. D'Souza was down the right side, but Canton didn't even really look over. Here's a quick shot there by Hishon that Anderson gets a piece of. And look at this big gift. And Canton just is shooting all the way. Doesn't even look over at D'Souza. Shaw back there just in case. Face off in Owen Sound territory.
Again, Canton realizing, too, if he makes that pass and it doesn't work, you've got two players going the wrong way. Another chance here, shorthanded. Shug fires wide. And he also made sure on that shot that he, if he's going to miss, he's going to make the goaltender make a save and not fire it hard off the boards and have it whip around and catch the Majors again. Already shorthanded, down another man. 3 seconds to go on the power play for Owen Sound. Here's a chance now. McNardy holds on to it. Anderson the save. Loose puck in front. Now another breakaway chance. Casey Cizikas on his own out of the penalty box. Cizikas protects the puck. Can't get the shot away. Is this a penalty shot?
Yes, it is.
Penalty shot for the captain. He's got one goal tonight. And if he scores here, the Majors could take a 5-1 lead. He'll line it up at center.
Boy, everybody loves a penalty shot, don't they? Watch Cizikas break in, and it's a legitimate scoring chance. And when there is a breakaway scoring chance, the call is usually penalty shot. Casey Cizikas has a goal tonight, and at 18-13 has a penalty shot opportunity, and Mark Reeds can only watch. This is fun.
Here comes the captain, Casey Cizikas, against Stager. Cizikas takes the shot, and Stager stays tall and makes the save. Great stop by Stager.
Stager gave him nothing to shoot at as he takes the water, slams the bottle down, and that's just closing the door is right. 6'3", 200-pound, big body there, and Cizikas just fired right into him. It's nice work by the Owen Sound goaltender, and that keeps the attack alive. And Casey with a smile on the bench saying, oh, well, that's probably why you shouldn't have me in shootouts. Right into the blocker. Nice stop.
Face-off win by St. Mike's. Kitson in the corner. Keevan Cutting pins him against the boards. Rob Flick and Helis keeping watch for the loose puck. Kitson on his knees, gets back up again. Using that strength of his,
comes out to the circle. Nice little layoff pass. Shot to the net. Rebound comes out. Still down low. Kitson leaning in on the puck. Can't get his stick free to take a shot in the crowd. But whatever conversation Cizikas had with Kitson seems to be working as he's starting just to battle through all that extra attention. Now Mayer. Couldn't get the puck deep. Maidens. One too many moves trying to gain the zone of the Majors. Just take the puck away. 1 minute to go now in the second period of play. A period in which the Majors have opened this one up. J.P. Anderson steers that one to the boards. Ahead of Childerly. Mayer comes up with a puck. Canton behind the net. Rob Flick. There it is. Soft off the boards. Kitson near the end of a shift. Gains the zone. Takes the shot. That's deflected wide. Kitson still got that busy stick, though, as he goes to the bench. And now it's Helmo just tipping it over the line. Majors get it back again. Wide open wing here for Bureau, but puck doesn't find him. 20 seconds to go as Fleming backs up in his own end. Riley Brace facing the glass. Stanish lets up. Just a little shove as the puck now comes to Stanish on the near boards. Trying to backhand it out of the zone. Majors keep it in. Bureau against Blacker. Stanish takes a hit from Wise. 4 seconds to go. Majors, can they pop one out front? Nope. Bureau's pinned to the boards. That'll do it. And then Wise with a shove. Wise is going to go, I guess.
Not a Wise penalty for Jamie Wise, Dan, because the period's over. You get a three-goal lead. You got all the momentum. And now you give the visitors a power play at the start of the third period and a chance at a little momentum. And you can bet the attacker just going to let Jamie Wise skate off here. And he shakes his head as he goes off to the Majors bench. Three goals. Go ahead, Dan.
Sorry, I was going to say, Dave Cameron looking up at the board. I think he's more miffed at the call than he is Jamie. It looked like Jamie just shoved the Owen Sound player who fell down as the puck was at their feet. And I can tell by that look by Dave Cameron. If it was Jamie Wise he was all that upset with, he'd be following Jamie down the tunnel right now.
Now, I don't know if he's calling coincidental minors or not. It looked like the referee might be, but we'll have to see. Nothing will be up on the scoreboard yet, but Dave Cameron wants an explanation, wants to talk to the referee, and he's not going to get a conversation from the referee. And Dave Cameron will give him a few words as he goes off. So I think it's fair enough to say it's going to be an Owen Sound power play at the start of the third period. Three goals, and it is just one penalty up on the board. Three goals in 10 minutes and 16 seconds in that second period as the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors lead 4-1 after two. Time for the thoughts of our panel. Well, let's go downstairs to Ben Ennis.
Thanks a lot, Raj, and you don't often see a head coach leading a game 4-1, leave the ice after 40 minutes and be that angry, but Dave Cameron not happy with whatever the call was on Jamie Wise. We're not sure right now. Ben Ennis, Michelle Storino, Matt Scooby here atop the Hershey Center. The Majors leading the Owen Sound attack 4-1. Here's another look at the hit. It was a hit from behind, guys. I don't know how you want to call that one. It wasn't a particularly hard one. Maybe that was the penalty there. Started off with a hit from behind, though.
I think it might have been after the whistle, or I didn't see what you can't see where the whistle ends on that one, but I think it might have been after the whistle, and whatever occurred after, I think, is what Dave Cameron was upset about.
Yeah, the retaliation there by Wise wasn't exactly the wisest. It was Jamie unwise finishing the period for the Mississauga Majors. You know, a little bit of play on words there, Ben, you know?
Yeah, that was really nice.
Thanks.
I hope we get more puns here in this intermission. But first, let's throw it downstairs to Alicia Warner and Brett Fleming.
Thank you, guys. Brett Fleming, defenseman of the Majors, here with me. Solid second period for you guys. Three goals to break ahead 4-1, but you're starting the third shorthanded. What are your thoughts on the first 40?
Well, you know, I think we played real strong. The first was a little slow, but that's what happens when you haven't played in a week. And, you know, we came out in the second and played real strong, got pucks to the net, and we're going to continue to do that.
You've been here with this team, it's your fourth season now, and every year you've been here in the postseason, you've consistently gotten better by around each year. Can you talk about maybe like the bonding experience that happens to a team like that when you've been together that long?
Well, you know, chemistry is a huge thing. Playing together with the same pairings and lines the whole year really builds chemistry. And you know what, I think we have a good bond in the room, and I think that helps us.
Do you guys prepare any differently for a team like Owen Sound? Not to, you know, take any credit away from teams like Belleville or Sudbury, but you know they're a number one seed coming in the West. Do you prepare any differently for a team like that?
Every team's different, so we watch video and we know what they're going to do and they know what we're going to do. So, yeah, we do prepare different for each and every team.
Finally, we touched on the fact that you're going to be shorthanded to start the third. What do you have to do in the last 20 minutes to hang on for the winning game one?
Well, first, I think we had to kill this penalty. I think we've been doing a good job so far and just continue to play the way we have been.
Brett Fleming of the Majors, who lead the Owen Sound attack 4-1 here in the second intermission. After the break, game notes. You're watching OHL Hockey, the OHL final.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Approximately 8% of adults
will experience major depression
at some time in their life.
Once depression is recognized,
help can make a difference for 80% of people who are affected,
allowing them to get back to their regular activities.
By age 40,
about 50% of the population will have
or have had a mental illness.
Rogers TV is a proud community partner
in supporting Mental Health Week.
Hashtag get real about how you feel.
Gentlemen,
we can work together.
This world is not yet ready.
I can feel it happening.
We don't want more violence.
Welcome to the afterlife.
Congratulations, gentlemen.
I'm Barb, and this is Star.
On Rogers TV, we have a reality show like no other. It has a great cast of characters. Some you may have even helped land the role. Each episode has something different. Plans are devised, decisions are made, votes are cast, and money is spent. It's local reality TV that you won't want to miss. And it's exclusive to Rogers Cable customers. Catch your municipal council coverage on Rogers TV. Visit RogersTV.com for broadcast details.
When it comes time to be on the ice, that's the only thing on your mind. And that's when you're on the ice in practice, you're trying to get better.
Welcome back. Game notes time. Ben Ennis, Michelle Storino, Matt Scooby. We got the Robertson Cup right in front of us. It's all shined up.
Yeah.
It's a lot bigger than the Bobby Orr Trophy, which I guess makes sense because it's for the OHL Championship, not just the Eastern Conference Championship.
A lot shinier as well.
Yeah, very neat to have it, though, with us. And, of course, goes to the winner of this OHL Championship Series. The Mississauga St. Michael's Majors leading the Owen Sound attack now 4-1 through 40 minutes of play, 1-1 heading into that second period. The Majors with three straight goals. They look amazing on the power play. Don't get one on the power play in that second period. Devontae Smith-Pelly had one in the first period. Created a ton of opportunities. If not for Stott, Stager might have been, I don't know, 6-1 for the Majors because he made a bunch of saves. But the Owen Sound attack, talked about it off the top, they're a high-scoring bunch. They know how to score. The Majors had the most goals in the OHL during the regular season. The Owen Sound attack, second most. So I think the attack probably not happy with this 4-1 deficit, but something they feel that with the high-powered offense they have an opportunity to come back.
Well, Ben, don't you find it maybe a little bit ironic? Matt Petgrave in the first intermission interview said Mississauga can't keep up with our speed and our run-and-gun style. And what happened? He got called for a penalty shot when Casey Zizekas was going in with his speed
beat
and
him
beat him. Beat him with speed. need, right? So that's what this Mississauga St. Michael's Majors is doing, the exact opposite of what Matt Petgrave's Owen Sound attack are usually used to, right? So my question is, how do you stop the first two lines of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors? They're, right now they have obviously four very balanced lines, but those are the two lines generating all the offense, right? You have Devontae Smith-Pelly with the two goals, Casey Cizikas with that opportunity, of course, and then of course D'Souza scoring as well. So how do you stop these top two lines if you're the Owen Sound attack and Mark Reeves?
I don't think they can stop them at this point, really, so far in this game, is that I think Petgrave, he jinxed them.
Right.
He jinxed the attack in that third period as well at this point, because it was really just all Majors all the time. They outshot the attack 21-7 in that period. They won the face-off battle of 13-10. And then they also, you know, on the score sheet, 43 goals, 43 seconds apart to make it 4-1. And as much as high-powered offense as the attack have been, if you go back and look at it, the Majors did not win it, did not lose a game in 37 games in the regular season when leading after two periods, and 12 games in these playoffs out of 13 when they've been leading after two periods have not lost the game. So as much as the guys talk about it on the broadcast as well, you can beat a dead horse, you know, to death pretty much, but it's just like this Dave Cameron Hockey Club is going to be, it's going to be very, very difficult for the Owen Sound to get any kind of momentum going here in the third period.
Well, not only that, the Majors haven't lost on home ice during the playoffs. They've only lost one game overall. They've won 22 of their last 23 games. My God,
so
a lot of wins.
Do you mind me asking you guys a question? So you mentioned obviously Scott Seager keeping the Owen Sound attack in this game, and it would be 6-7-1 by now if it wasn't for him. But you're Mark Reeves, do you want, maybe you want to change momentum? I know Jordan Binnington is dressed, it's not Michael Zadora, but both guys having pretty decent playoffs. Do you switch things up if you're Mark Reeves? Just get a spark going in your team?
I don't know if that's the move you make right here. Like you mentioned, and like we saw in that second period, a couple of chances at least that were absolute larceny by Scott Stager, and he just robbed Michael D'Orazio with the side of the net on the power play. There was another save later in that period as well. Not coming to my mind right now, but a couple of huge saves, one on the rebound by Scott Stager.
D'Souza,
he was great in that period despite allowing the three goals.
I agree. When you give up, you know, like 21 saves in that in the second period as well, he was peppered, and I don't think you can really blame it on him, but I don't think you can really get to give him his confidence. Or if Mark Reeves pulls him at this point, it just definitely decimates his confidence at this point, which I really don't think you can do. You have to stick with your goaltender right now. Not to deny that Zdor has been good or Benton's been good. I'm not saying that, but I don't think you can give up. Stager is the guy you've been with to the playoffs. You have to let him have this whole game so far.
So what do you do if you're Mark Reeves in order to come out this last 20 minutes and make a game of this?
Well, I mean, you have to stick to your game plan. I don't know what you can do. This is a great team they're playing right now, and they're playing a great, the Majors have a great game plan, and they've looked fantastic on the power play. Just stick to it. Just keep doing what you're doing. You were the second best team in the OHL during the regular season for a reason. But Matt, you wanted to talk about the face-offs in particular in this game.
It was an interesting thing to see. You know, actually kept face-off stats in that second period. The Majors won it 14-10, but there was a certain point in the period when Joe Cramarosa lost three draws in a row in the defensive zone. A couple of quick whistles. Anderson made a couple of saves. Dave Cameron, being the coach that he is, it's unacceptable, so he puts out Corey Bureau. Doesn't change the whole line. Just substitute Bureau for Cramarosa. Bureau comes in, wins a face-off, and off they go. He ended up making the line change when there was a face-off not too long later. But it's just those little things in the game that Cameron is so good at noticing. Maybe not the hardest thing to notice for a head coach when a centerman loses three face-offs in a row. But again, on the penalty kill as well, Casey Cizikas in the box. The Majors won a couple of big draws on that penalty kill as well. They were able to clear the puck out of their zone as a result. So give Cameron some credit. Sees Cramarosa struggling. After that, he kind of picked it up. Won two out of four draws after that one, or after that little mess up, so to speak. But again, the little things like that are what makes Dave Cameron such a good coach. Also, why you talk about why he's yelling at a 4-1 game. That's Dave Cameron, and that's what he does.
Well, all three of us actually, while watching that second period of play, were noticing how good and how improved, or how much improvement the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors showed on the power play. Just the sense of confidence that maybe they didn't have before. And why do you think they were able to basically pass the puck in every lane? It looked like every lane was open for them, and all the one-timers were open. Just why do you think that happened for them in that second period especially?
It's a really good hockey team.
Yeah.
They're really well coached.
Yeah.
And they got really great players.
Wow.
And they're really good. And
these
they're playing at home.
Very good answers. Very true answers.
Yeah.
Right now as well. Yeah.
you know what? This is a great team. There's only so many ways we can say it. They're a great team. I mean, the power play in the regular season, it was one of their sore spots. They were not great on the power play. Penalty kill as well during the regular season was not one of their strong suits. So that was a surprise, but I don't think it's a surprise that they turned it around here in the playoffs with a great penalty kill that allowed a goal on the man disadvantage here in this game. But the power plays look great. Shorthanded has looked great. And as a result, they have a 4-1 lead through 40 minutes of play. The Majors have a very long history and a couple of Memorial Cups, not in Mississauga, but back in the old days. Here's that story.
The year was 1944, and Joe Primo had taken over as head coach. The previous season, the Majors had proven they were back on top, meeting the Oshawa Generals in the Ontario Hockey Association final. But the Double Blue were taking on the new Top Guns. Oshawa had won 6 consecutive league championships and reached the Memorial Cup final 5 of the previous 6 seasons. And in 1944, history repeated itself. The Generals won 5 games to hoist the Memorial Cup as the Majors looked on. With redemption on their minds, the Majors did what they do best today, winning. Early in the season, St. Mike's pummeled the Generals 12-1 at Oshawa Arena. The message was sent loud and clear. This team was going for number one. In their 1944-45 season, they did just that, finishing in first and snapping a streak Oshawa owned for 7 years. It was round one of the playoffs, and the Majors were back to their old ways, making easy work of the competition. In their best of 7 group semifinals, they devoured the St. Catharines Falcons in 5 games. Moving on to the OHA Junior A final, St. Mike's made a clean sweep of the Galt Red Wings and captured the John Ross Robertson Cup as 1945 champs. Their next victims might as well have just stayed home. In the All-Ontario final against the NOHA champions, the Porcupine Combines, the Majors won 3 straight in a best of 5 series. In true hockey fashion, Toronto faced off against the Montreal Royals in the Eastern Canadian final. It was here that the boys had faced their first real challenge, overcoming an obstacle they had not previously encountered, coming back after losing game 1. Montreal stole a win 3-1, but the Majors stormed back and won the series in 6 games, earning the Richardson Trophy for the first time since their last Memorial Cup win in 1934. Out of the West were the Moose Jaw Canucks. With St. Mike's familiar on home ground territory at Maple Leaf Gardens, they went on to win game 1 8-5 in front of 12,420 fans. Moose Jaw tied the series at 1 apiece, stealing game 2 5-3. But then the Majors never looked back, winning games 3 and 4 in 2 scrappy matchups. And then only 1 game to go. Game 5. Fan attendance had broken previous records with 65,437 in 5 games, and they wouldn't be disappointed. On April 23, 1945, the St. Michael's Majors thumped Moose Jaw 7-2 and hoisted the Memorial Cup. And then there were 2.
Welcome back, for real, inside the Hershey Center. Ben Ennis, joined now by Laura Barney, who put that story together. Laura, last time we talked about the story that you did previous, we talked about the fedoras, which I love. I love that old-time footage. I mean, this franchise, just so much history. It goes back such a long way. How much have you enjoyed looking at these old footage of old games and learning a little bit about the history of the Majors?
You took the words right out of my mouth. It's so nice to actually get a chance to see it, especially with this right in front of us. Here it is, Ben. You get to see history. You get to touch it. You get to learn so much about it. Seeing the pictures, even in the books, they're so detailed. I think to myself, oh, my gosh, I was there, and getting to see what was put together. I'm learning so much, and I'm absolutely loving it. There is so much history right in front of us, and I just think it's so important for people to know as well.
Yeah, the Robertson Cup going to be awarded to the winner of this series as the OHL champion, and the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors battling for it for the first time in their franchise history. But of course, you go back to the Majors on their first time they existed in Toronto, Bathurst and St. Clair. A lot of history for the Majors. And when the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors will be in the Memorial Cup along with the Owen Sound Attack, Rogers TV is going to have a pregame show before every single game, so make sure you check out Rogers TV before every single Memorial Cup game that the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors play. For more on what's happening around the CHL, let's throw it back upstairs to Brad and Will.
Yeah, thank you, Ben. A lot going on across the country, actually even beyond our country overall. But New Brunswick, Quebec, BC, Oregon, the focus tonight is in Quebec because that's where Big Game 7 is being played well.
Yeah, it's the semifinal series between the Quebec Ramparts and the Gatineau Olympiques. And now that is a 2-2 game in the third period. That third period is underway. It's Gatineau leading up 2-0 after the first, Quebec scoring twice in the second. So it's a close one in Game 7 there in Quebec City.
Yeah, Quebec, of course, storming back in this game, but Gatineau is storming back in the series. It was 3-1. Gatineau won 5-4 at home, and then 4-0 in Quebec City to set up this big Game 7. Real quickly out west, what's the situation there?
Well, the final series in the WHL is set, and that's going to be between the Portland Winterhawks and the Kootenay Ice. Kootenay is on fire. They've won an amazing 11 straight games, including two straight series sweeps. So they're the favorites, even though Portland is the number one seed in the West, Kootenay the four seed in the East.
There you have it out West. We'll have a full update on what happened in the third period in that close Quebec game after this game. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, guys. Casey Suzuki is scoring along with Devontae Smith-Pelly is second of the goal, and Chris D'Souza, the goal scorers in the second period. Three straight goals for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. They enjoy that 4-1 lead heading into the third period against the Owen Sound Attack. Final stanza coming up.
Majors. The beginning of this Rogers Championship Series sees the Majors ahead after two periods.
Scores! That might be the nail. Casey Cizikas, the captain!
Their ever-resilient attack look to keep their heads up and exit the Hershey Center with a road win.
Nice pass! Oh, what a beauty! Owen Sound scores!
Can the Majors hold on and walk away with a series lead?
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the OnSound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our OnSound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Are you the type who would keep going or stop? It's not easy to stop when you have an addiction. Legalizing cannabis won't stop addiction. It trivializes its consumption. Let's be vigilant. If you need help, visit portage.ca.
Don't forget to join us on Grey County Life at Home next week.
We're going to be talking with Paula Kermacki from the Women's Center Grey Bruce.
In Canada, only one in five children
who need mental health services receives them.
By age 40, about 50% of the population will have
or have had a mental illness.
Once depression is recognized,
help can make a difference
for 80% of people who are affected,
allowing them to get back to their regular activities.
Rogers TV is a proud community partner
in supporting Mental Health Week.
Hashtag get real about how you feel.
Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m., it's the RTV quiz. Giovanni Petiti hosts a weekly trivia competition that lets you play from the comfort of your couch. Play along at home and challenge your friends. And don't forget to follow along on social media. Let us know who's top of trivia and you can find yourself featured on a future episode.
Are you kidding me, folks?
The RTV quiz, Wednesday nights at 7:30 p.m. on Rogers TV or at rogerstv.com/RTVquiz.
Now you can enjoy the Amazon Prime Video app on Ignite TV. Just say Amazon Prime Video into your Ignite voice remote and watch Amazon originals like The Expanse.
They wanted to fight. We'll give them one.
The Wilds.
Are we in the actual Bermuda Triangle?
And The Boys.
That is amazing.
Prime members can stream Amazon originals, movies, TV shows, and more on Ignite TV today. Now you're in command.
It's not the series right now for the Owen Sound Attack, but it might very well be the most pivotal point of this game number one. Starting period three in the power play, down 4-1. Dan Dunleavy along with Roger Lajoie, Blacker and company will try to cut this lead in half and give themselves as much time as possible to work from there.
1-for-3, Owen Sound on the power play, a full 2 minutes after that penalty to Wise at the 20-minute mark of the second period.
Keeping in mind the last power play opportunity for the Owen Sound attack resulted in three very good scoring chances for the Majors, and here they come again. Cizikas and Shug. Shug will just hold at the line. Cizikas didn't get the puck deep enough to change. Captain with a goal so far tonight, Devonte Smith-Pelly with a pair for Mississauga.
Percy bails out Cizikas there, who didn't, as you said, Dan, get it deep enough for a change, but Percy's icing allows the Majors to get fresh legs out there.
Pass too far and icing on the play. Fritsch couldn't get to the puck, and hopefully he's only having trouble getting up because of the ice surface. And yes, he's back up and headed to the bench on a change. 53 seconds into period three.
And face off inside Owen Sound territories. We look at Dylan DeMello, one of the Majors' defenders, and we talked about them rolling their forward lines. They roll their defensemen, do a tremendous job.
Puck fire down the ice. Stasier out to his left, and he'll leave it. 54 seconds left in the power play. Here come the attack. Petgrave to center ice. Now Shaw takes a look as he gains his own. Right side Canton strips him of the puck and moves it quickly to Mello. His clearing attempt went off the skate of D'Souza, and Owen Sound able to keep the pressure on here for another chance on the power play. 33 seconds. Shemich up top. Petgrave. Here's a chance in a wide open net. McNarty, his second of the game. And that's the goal Owen Sound needed to keep this a game in the third period, now trailing 4-2.
Well, the Majors are going to learn the lesson of staying out of the penalty box at some point in this series if they want to win, because for the second time on the power play, McNarty finds himself all alone. First time was for a shot to the left side, this time right side. Watch the left to right side of the goal. McNarty's in the crease by himself. Nobody around him. Easy goal. On the backhand, Anderson has no chance. Three blue shirts in front, nobody near McNarty, who is unguarded. And we got a 4-2 game.
That was one of those moments where you don't see it a whole lot, but the Majors got caught puck watching. All four heads you saw in that replay that Roger was describing to you, everybody staring at the puck. Nobody had a shoulder check to see who was coming down. Now, you can't help the fact somebody's open, but boy, that was wide open.
Dave Cameron has given a speech at the bench. He does not like the way this third period has started, obviously, with that power play goal, and letting the boys in blue know it's a three-period game. You cannot let up in the OHL Championship Final. And as you mentioned, Dan, they let up a little bit. It's a power play goal, granted, but they let up a little bit.
Big hit. Helas got brace. And J.P. Anderson makes his stop. Moments like that can turn the momentum of a game as cutting comes over, gives Helas a tap. Brace is right behind him now, having a little chat, saying, I'm fine if that's all you got, but this is a beautiful hit.
No question, clean, open ice hit.
Yep.
Down goes Brace, shoulder to shoulder. Helas also going down with the impact of that hit.
You know what, and it's a shame we have to say this, but we applaud both players. There was actually an open ice hit and no fight afterwards.
No, no pushing, no shoving. Now, Brace said a few words for Helas just to let him know.
Oh yeah, they might scrap another time, but at least at least they let it go after the hit for a change.
I think it's just a case it'll be a hit another time. Yeah. Two can play at that game. I don't think that's a setup on anything.
And Dave Cameron's all over the referee right now.
Line change here. The not allow last line change Majors wanted to make. And with the faceoff in Majors territory, Dave Cameron wants to know why.
Little Lemmy ace of spades. The arena must be playoff time. 11th postseason goal for McNarty. And here comes Helas. He delivered that big hit, trying to walk his way through the defense. McNarty stays on the ice, trying to manufacture another one. Smith-Pelly. Ahead of Maidens, plays it behind the goal. Percy, look out, almost stripped of the puck. Helas almost stole it. Majors having trouble coping with this forecheck of the attack, and this is what we saw from Owen Sound to start the game, and the Majors really didn't have a lot of puck possession in the first period. Pretty sure that was the talk in the second from the Owen Sound coaching staff, and there's a lot of coaching going on the bench right now for the attack as well as they change it up.
Let's not forget Mark Reeds is the OHL Coach of the Year. Dave Cameron, second team All-Stars coach. Both these teams know how to adapt. That's why you see such momentum swings, Dan, ebb and flow to the game. Coaches kind of readjust the game plan between periods, and clearly Owen Sound has come up with a lot more juice and a lot more determination here in period three. Icing call there, 3:14 into the third period, and we got ourselves a game.
Well, McNardy, of course, having himself a big game here tonight. He set a new Owen Sound franchise record for plus minus in a season, finished at a plus 35 rating. Bobby Ryan had the previous mark of plus 33, so you know he's going to continue to be a factor throughout this championship series and in the Memorial Cup as well. So we'll keep our eyes on the continued solid performance of Robbie McNardy. Number 10 for the attack, Mark Canton. Speaking of solid, he has been that all year for St. Mike's, paired with DeMello for the most part of the season. D'Souza from Kitson. Kitson wants it back again, but offside of the play. Rob Flick was dragged in over the line, and faceoff will come outside the blue line.
Well, this is a key couple of minutes here, as you mentioned, Dan, at the start of this third period. Not in this series, but in this game. The attack answer back, and that penalty to Wise, didn't that turn out to be costly, as I said, at the end of a period? All the momentum was with the Majors at the end of two. They had the three goals in 10 minutes and 16 seconds. Visitors are down 4-1. Wise takes the penalty. Power play goal to Owen Sound, and now this game's got a completely different feel to it here early in the third period. Still 4-2 Mississauga, but Owen Sound very much still in the hockey game.
Ishan on the ice for the attack. Kitson flick into D'Souza for the Majors. D'Souza delivers a hit along the boards. Puck comes back to him. Down low with Kitson. D'Souza spun off the puck. No shot, no chance. And the attack to center ice. Turn the puck right back over again. Shemitz. Near side for Stanis. Backhand pass to center ice. Ishan turns away from Rob Flick. Opens up a lane for Wilson down the wing, but Percy's there, and look out. Is that going off somebody?
No, I don't think so. That's a penalty.
And the door opens, and there goes Percy.
Well, Majors are playing with fire here. Owen Sound, 2-for-4 on the power play. And that's a tough luck blow more than is anything else to delay a game penalty. But boy, the way McNardy in the attack, and they're chomping at the bit to get out here for this power play. And why not? They dropped that puck fairly, so they'll do it again. 4:10 is the time of the penalty to Percy.
This is where Casey Cizikas will do Dave Cameron hopes one of those little things that he does so well. McNardy and Cizikas on the draw. Casey with a goal today, and speaking with some of the members of the media up here, they're saying, boy, Casey hasn't scored a lot this year. And I said, well, it's really not what Casey does. He will score, but it's the penalty kill, the face-offs, and the leadership. And we saw it when he dressed for his country at the World Junior Hockey Championships. And right there is why he's on the ice. Won the face-off. Shug. Chance to clear it, and he finds a lane all the way down the ice. A roller, Stager has to be careful with it. Petgrave now to center. Pass McNardy, can't get it. Cizikas, shorthanded, leaning in. Cizikas, who had a penalty shot in this game, stopped by Stager earlier, back in the second period. Certainly started his penalty kill shift off well, and now is on the bench as the Majors again steal. No offside, and
another
a high
penalty
stick coming up. Yeah, with 1:22 remaining in the current penalty, and Stager's going to the bench. Majors finish up the change and get the puck quickly. Jamie Wise touches up, and a two-man advantage coming up now. The Majors with a 4-2 lead and in big, big trouble. Now, I don't know if Canton thinks that it was sold too much. Canton claiming that maybe didn't get him. I don't know.
Well, we'll see if we can pick it up here on the replay. Well, we saw the tail end of it there. Maybe we'll get that back again and have a look. But Canton is really irate. Now the referee is checking to see. Casey Zekas was, or rather, Michael D'Orazio's there. And what are they bringing? Another player to the penalty box here? What is this call?
There's some real chomping going on between the two benches right now. At that angle I couldn't see, but I wonder if the Majors think that he sold a high stick that never happened, and maybe that's what's going to be called here, unsportsmanlike.
We have
that's what it is. I think
the Owen Sound box is open, so we got another penalty coming to the attack here. And that is a break for the majors. Well, a shot.
It is. It's unsportsmanlike. Yep. He tried to sell the high stick. That didn't happen.
Then why do you call the penalty?
If it wasn't a high stick.
That's right.
I agree.
I'm sorry. I don't get that one. Never have. 2 minutes for high sticking and 2 minutes for faking that you were high stick. How's that possible?
It's not possible. Canton's standing up as if he says, come on, let me out of here. I never high-sticked anybody.
Yeah, so I get a penalty, so we both sit for two. And Canton, a pretty valuable penalty killer for the majors. All right, well, it remains 5-on-4. Still 1:15 to go in the Percy penalty is one of the pet peeves of this league. Well, not this league. It's a hockey rule. You can call the penalty and diving at the same time or unsportsmanlike conduct. Now, I don't know what the problem is with the board here. They can't get the guest penalty up on the board. Now, you see, talk about taking momentum out of a hockey game. Now they just get rid of the two minutes. There we go.
Mission won the faceoff this time as we get back to the play, and Blacker up top along with Stanish. A goal here by the attack, and we've got ourselves a one-goal game. Majors had a 4-1 lead to start this period. J.P. Anderson will cover up and hold on with 1:01 remaining in the power play for Owen Sound.
So the faceoff will be to the right of J.P. Anderson. And again, we mentioned the pressure. Your goaltender's got to be your best penalty killer. Boy, what a turnaround in this game when you consider just before that Wise penalty, again, at the 20-minute mark, the Majors at a 4-1 lead were in control, and if Owen Sound can get one here, look out.
Well, it's very reminiscent, if they do, of a situation that happened with Mississauga earlier this season when Riley Brace took an ill-timed penalty while he was on the Majors bench, and Riley Brace didn't see the ice, didn't dress for a number of games after that incident. It was a selfish play at the time. I'm sure when it happened in the moment, when he made contact with the player on the ice, he was trying to defend a teammate. But just like Jamie Wise at the end of the period, Dave Cameron quickly reminded him there was no good to be had from that action. So slashing is the call on Canton. There was no slash.
Well, that's what I mean. Unsportsmanlike conduct was the penalty for, you know, like, at any rate.
McNarty with Hishon going to the net. Can't get on the puck. Here's a chance, and it's fired wide.
Penalty has expired, so the Majors bottom line with a big kill. Still two players in the box, but coincidental minors, teams back to five aside.
McNarty for Helas. What a game by McNarty. Helas can't get the shot cutting. He'll keep it in. Bouncing puck in the corner. McNarty, too much time there, but closed in quickly by Mississauga's Corrente. Native of Mississauga to Mello, with Helmo battling him in the corner. McNarty, pass back to the point. Bouncing puck, Anderson, no rebound whatsoever, holds on. Faceoff will be to his right. 13:16 to go. Third period, 4-2, Mississauga.
Well, you always need good goaltending, and you need it now as the Owen Sound attack getting some momentum here. Thanks to that guy in particular, McNarty, with a couple of power play goals. But Anderson has answered the bell. He's only had to face 20 shots on goal in this game, but a couple of tough ones, big saves, and you can't blame him on either of McNarty's goals as he was left alone in front. But Owen Sound getting some pressure, and Smith Pelly takes another puck. This one looks like off the shin or the ankle.
Yeah, it was a roller. Gilbert at his own blue line, rink wide. Maidens working against Fleming. Cizikas off the boards and out. You can see that coming. Took the hit, but whatever it takes to get the puck out in the neutral zone, Majors will do it. The attack will do the very same. Helas at center ice. Battling with Kent. Now Gilbert backing up. Off of cutting stick, and he gets some help from Maidens. The Grimsby native will come out from behind his own goal. Drop pass as the Majors put two in deep to forecheck. Both Shug and Bureau going wide to break out his Brace, and the backhand wide on the mark. Referee ducks out of the way. Schoenmakers to the line, tips it out towards center. Grammarosa just got that puck in Owen Sound territory, sidestepped a hit. Schoenmakers gloved it down, kept it in. Far side for Helas. To the line, not out, kept in. D'Orazio tried to shoot it in deep, it went off a skate. And now it's Brace the other way. On his own, knocked to the ice by Corrente. And the loose puck to Mello. minutes away from an Owen Sound attack sandwich there, and the Majors, Vural, will ice the puck. Not sure he meant to put that one all the way down the ice, but 11:52 to go in the third. Faceoff will be back in Mississauga territory.
I'm sure he didn't mean to ice it as we look at Joe Cramarosa, who came up big in the Niagara series, had a big two-goal game in Game 4 when the Majors reestablished themselves in St. Catharines and with a 6-1 win, then went on to win Game 5 4-1. A little bit of inconsistency in Cramarosa's play, but at times this year has shown flashes of the kind of OHL player he can be. A lot of teams in this league with their eye on Cramarosa down the road is being a big-time contributor here for the Majors as Dave Cameron tries to keep that bench pumped up.
Shot off the side of the net. Majors now to their own blue line. No possession. Mayer has it knocked away. Jamel Smith. Now Canton. Nice move out of the corner. Mayer to his own blue line into center ice. Little backhander ahead of Brace. Petgrave back after it. Petgrave almost gave it away. Wise playing deep, but tipped well by Jamel Smith, who plays it ahead, and now it's lifted deep. And J.P. Anderson will hold that shoot in by Helmo. And more nonsense after the whistle. Owen Sound trying to get in the headspace of J.P. Anderson, the Majors defenseman, trying to box him out. I think referee might be sending a couple of guys to the box. He's had enough. And this stuff has been going on the entire game.
Well, it's pretty good strategy, though, if you're Owen Sound. First of all, to try to rattle the cage of J.P. Anderson. And secondly, of course, to do everything you can do to maybe draw the Majors into an extra minor. It's an innocent enough looking play. It flicks into Anderson. Easy glove save, and the nonsense starts right after that. And there will be coincidental minor penalties at 8:39. Petgrave has a shrug as he goes off. Riley Brace, the Major, off. And Dave Cameron, never a happy guy, an intense guy during the games, barking out the orders down the bench. 11:21 to go in this third period. That's lots of time.
Zizekas and Hish in the faceoff to the right of J.P. Anderson. Draw one cleanly by Owen Sound, but cleared out to center ice in cutting. Backing up, pressured by Shug. Zizekas already inside the Owen Sound line, gets a stick on it. Pass up ice intended for Hishin. Blocked, and now Percy. Bit of a sloppy pass in front of his own net. Got away with it. Fleming there to help him out. Now Shug to center ice. Working the left wing. Percy the trailer. He'll overlap and go down low with Zizekas. Cutting trying to stay with the Majors captain. Coming down is Fleming to keep it deep. Shug off his skate. Tries to walk it out front. Zizekas was coming down to the post. Stanish. Soft pass ahead, but space granted by Percy. That allows Hishin the Majors zone and a rolling puck. Gobbled up by Percy. Draft eligible defenseman then stripped by Hishin. Devontae Smith Pelly now with some hop as he gets to center ice. He's got two on the night. Smith Pelly trying to bowl his way through the coverage of Jay Gilbert, Port Stanley native. Then Gilbert takes a hit from Mayer. Canton sees it open up at center ice. Canton dropped for Mayer. Mayer thought Canton was keeping, and he didn't want to jump into the play. Now Shaw on the left wing. DeMetal tips it ahead of him. Under 10 minutes to go, 9:53 to be exact here in period number three. McNarty, already got a couple, looking for another one. Pad save Anderson. Shaw on the rebound in the corner. DeMetal watching him. Nice move by Shaw. Walks out in front. Pad save Anderson. Fired that left leg out. Canton reaching for it. Can't get there. McNarty dragged down. Holds on to the stick of Mayer. No call. And the attack will counter the center ice.
All Owen Sound gets a break there as Mayer was clearly held up. And Dave Cameron giving it to the ref. That time justified. Sometimes you make a statement, but boy, that was pretty obvious.
Riley Brace on the left wing has Rob Flick with him on this rush. Majors up 4-2. There's a rebound in front. Kitson can't get a stick on it. Dave Cameron still all over the referee, who bravely takes his spot right in front of the Majors bench. Nothing he hasn't heard before. Parente looks up ice. Sees Kitson ahead of him. Kitson looking down for it. Went off his sticks. So no icing on the play. Stanish ahead of Maxim Kitson. Rob Flick coming down. Parente at the point. Keeps it in. Takes a hit. Can't get it deep. Rob Flick coming up. Puck in his skates at center ice. Now Helas has it. Helas lays it off on the left wing. The attack with Helas going to the net. No wraparound attempt there. Ekgrave using his speed. Plays it back to the point. Halmo finds a lane, but shot about a half mile wide. Kick back. Ekgrave holds it. No shot. Through a traffic, and that one deflects wide.
It's exactly what you want to do if you're Owen Sound. Just keep the puck low from the point, get traffic in front, and tell you what, that one didn't miss by much.
Mississauga native Corrente off the boards and down the ice. No icing. Linesman waves it off. Majors catch a break.
They did catch a break because that was icing.
Dave Cameron now on the bench. You can still hear him up here, but he's going after his own players. He's not going after the referee now. Riley Brace, from game one to this point of the season, nothing has changed with the Majors modus operandi from Dave Cameron to every single player on the ice. This is what you saw if you came to the rink in game one of the season, game 35, and right now in the championship final. As we get a whistle on the play, 7:28 to go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from tonight's series opener.
Ontario Hockey League Championship Series for the J. Ross Robertson Trophy takes place Thursday, May 5th at 7 p.m. That broadcast will be available at Rogers Sportsnet. And Game 3, our Rogers TV crew right back here at the Hershey Center Friday, May 6th, 7:30 p.m. You can get your tickets online at Ticketmaster.ca. And looking ahead to Game 4, Rogers Sportsnet also has that one on Sunday, May the 8th at 4:30 p.m. And those are the first four games, and if necessary, 5, 6, and 7. But we'll worry about those later in the week. Well, right now, the Majors trying to worry about this two-goal lead.
No doubt. We want to welcome our friend Peter Labardius back from Alberta. He'll be calling those games on Sportsnet, and we hope that Rob Falls is doing well.
Had some surgery and
knee surgery.
Recuperating. He's going to be fine, ready for the Memorial Cup, and our best to Falsy, and boy, it will be wonderful to see Peter. What an energetic guy he is.
As a Falsy, see what happens when you try to take up MMA in your own backyard. Just knock it off. Owen Sound with a big line out here trying to make this a one-goal game in time to make a game of it. Hishon, along with Garrett Wilson, trying to fuel the comeback in the Majors. Can't clear, and now it bounces outside the line, and there's your offside call. Unless the Majors clear. Look out, Smith Pelly. Puck was there, so what's the call going to be? Head was down.
There's no call.
Puck was there.
He was looking at the puck. He didn't want to touch it for the offside call, and Smith Pelly ran him over. Let's watch the play, and it doesn't want to touch it. Look, he's just letting it sit.
Well, he did go to touch it there a little bit. As soon as he reached for it, that's when Smith Pelly came in. Now, you could argue a charge there because he had him lined up. But if you're going to stand still on the ice at any point in time, it's going to look like a charge, isn't it?
So the faceoff goes back in Owen Sound territory. 6:37 to go in the third period. Devontae Smith Pelly with two goals for the Majors. That's the difference in the hockey game so far. This is, we talk about the Majors' MO and forte is protecting a lead. Owen Sound, though, has battled back many times in this postseason. That's a scenario here.
This game is a long way from done. We've got a wrestling match going on behind the plate. As the attack gets center ice, Anderson on the shoot-in. Will he hold on to it under pressure? No. Keeps it moving, and now Canton almost turned it over. As a matter of fact, he does. As Shaw stays with it. Save made by Anderson. Saw that one through a crowd somehow. Halmo, he takes the shot. Anderson the save, and again, absolutely nothing as far as rebounds go. And he'll hold on. Faceoff with 6:04 to go in the third.
Boy, Dave Cameron won't like that last series by the Majors. They just did not clear that puck with any authority out of their own zone. First Canton. Shaw gets a shot. Look at the big rebound. Then Fleck can't clear it.
weak backhand attempt, and Anderson forced to make the save. You get that opportunity to clear the puck, you've got to move it out quickly and with a bit more authority. Nice work, though, by Shaw, who is in deep. And give the attack some credit here. They have not backed off at all to this challenge in game one as they continue to make life miserable for the Majors defense at times in the Majors end of the rink. For the most part, the Majors do protect that puck well, but a couple of sloppy clearing plays almost got them in trouble.
Petgrave over the line, tripped up. Majors clear. Icing indicated and call with 5:42 to go on a 4-2 Mississauga lead here in period number three. It's game one of the championship series. As Roger mentioned, the folks up in Owen Sound are chomping at the bit for the series to get up the highway. Safe travels to everybody who plan to make their way up there and watch McNarty put on a show in front of the home fans. Great crowd up there, and we're glad you're watching with us tonight here in Mississauga.
That rink packed to the rafters, and
shot. Anderson makes the stop. Quick shot off the draw. Stanish.
Terrific fans. They love the O up in Owen Sound. And was there Wednesday when they wrapped it up against Windsor, and the fans all excited about the Memorial Cup and the OHL Finals. So exciting times for Mississauga. They've been looking for this all year, but boy, pretty exciting times in Owen Sound too. You know, they know they're playing May 20th.
How about
well.
This bounce here? Cizikas now. Puck settled for him. Puts it off the crossbar and the post. And a better shot there than they did on the breakaway. Look out, Petgrave just got out of the way. Cizikas on the turnover. He wants another crack at it. That one's going high. Petgrave, boy, he was a missile getting out of the way of the captain on that play.
And Cizikas just misses here. In fact, Dan, I think you're right. It got the post and the crossbar as the captain gets a big cheer as he skates off after a very energetic shift. Let's watch it. Down comes Cizikas. Shot. Now we don't get a look, great look there, but it bangs there. Just the goalpost, looks like. Came right back out. Then the attack come down. Petgrave almost was wiped out with the check there, but he survived. 5:02 to play, and we got some penalties coming now. Or no, they want to review that shot by Cizikas, which is not necessary. That clearly was the goalpost.
Yeah, it's kind of odd because now the public address announcer has to say no goal.
Yeah. When fans are going, well, what are you talking about? Yeah. It was off the goalpost.
Maybe you don't even announce that. We just let it go.
Well, it's the OHL final. You want to make sure the calls are right, but clearly that just hit the goalpost.
Face off now to the right of Stager. Shots 27-26 in favor of Mississauga. Despite the 4-2 scoreline, the game's been about that even, save for that 10-minute mark in the or 10-minute span, rather, in the second period when Mississauga just took it over. Scored two goals within 43 seconds in that second period as Anderson in center field. Shags that soft liner.
Well, the MasterCard Memorial Cup is coming up, of course, and Will and company have been looking after the out-of-town scores. Will, what's going on this evening?
Beat the Quebec Remparts in game seven of that semifinal series with three goals in the third period. So Gatineau will be facing St. John for the QMJHL championship.
All right, Will, thank you. Boy, that'll be a series. Gatineau with a great comeback, and they were one of the better teams in the Quebec League. So the rest of the league starting to take shape, Dan. And
look out, Anderson, tip save. Yeah, I always, you know, I have to be a little honest here. We're not supposed to cheer, but we can because we're not in the Quebec League. But I was kind of hoping we'd see Patrick Wall around the building for a week or so.
Yeah, me too, but that's not to be after Gatineau knocks out Quebec tonight. So Gatineau and St. John will battle for the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League championship as the Memorial Cup pitcher starts to get a little clearer. Boy, the St. John Sea Dogs have been the number one ranked team most of the year and have really not been tested so far in the Q playoffs. I love the answer. I asked Dave Cameron about that. How much are you watching in the other league playoffs? He says, not at all. And I said, really? He goes, well, if I was watching, I might have been watching Saskatoon. They were a ranked team. They got knocked out in the second round. Like, you really only have to start watching in the final. Only one team in the league is going to make it. Now, that series will be watched by major scouts, I'm sure.
4:08 on that whistle blown as we get a look at Andrew Fritz, Brantford native. Another six-footer at 180, and still a lot of time and room to grow for the big fellow who sits down. He's got the playoff beard on pretty well. A little sparse compared to some of the boys down there, although you and I can't compete. Face off to the left to Stanger. Garazio keeps the puck deep for the Majors. Stanish takes a look over his shoulder. Sees the pace of Corey Bureau there to keep it in for Mississauga for a moment. And then Corrente stands his man up on the blue line. Pace, though, coming over the line by Palmel, who's knocked down by Durazio. And then Palmel will let go of Durazio. Stick in front, tip just wide. Puck comes out front again. Anderson down. Well, that's two holding the stick penalties. The referees have just absolutely let go here in this third period that have caused some problems for the Majors. Bureau off the boards and out. And Owen Sound's got a lot left in the tank here. 3:28 to go. You got to push one by Anderson soon, though, to really put the heat on here in the latter stages. Anderson out to play it ahead of Percy. Mayer takes a look. Nice little tip. Rob Flick. He's got D'Souza jumping up in a trailer as well. Flick keeps it and fires it high. It takes a deflection. And the faceoff will stay in Owen Sound territory with 3:09 to go.
Well, the attack now out shooting the Majors 29-27 for what that stat is worth. And it's worth a lot in this third period. It's been a very good third period for Owen Sound. You're down 4-1 after two, your first goal. Well, obviously, you want to win the hockey game, but if you can't win the hockey game, win the period. And they have so far by a 1-0 score. But Dave Cameron is not concerned about that. He is just telling his guys, stay focused, same thing. As the arms folded and watches eagerly here with 3:09 to play, face off in Owen Sound territory as the Majors try to close out game one.
Mark Reed's over on the bench working it for Owen Sound, coaching nonstop, much like Dave Cameron. Roger mentioned coach of the year. The job he's done with this attack side. And Maidens now with a pass up ahead. Icing on the play here against Owen Sound as they try to work their way into Majors territory. It'll get awful clogged up as if it wasn't already by Mississauga. We'll be back here on Friday night. Hope to see this place packed for a Friday night game of the OHL final.
Good crowd expected on Friday night as well. Tickets going much better for the Friday night game three of the OHL finals. You can get your Memorial Cup tickets while you're in the building as well, because lots of hockey still coming in May here and lots of fight in this series. No question about it. This is advertised as the battle of two closely matched teams, and so far tonight that's been the case. So far the Majors just a little bit better.
Rolling puck in front of the net. Rob Flick fights for it. Brought it up high though, and now Fleming. A bit of a spot there against McNarty. Majors just fire it right back in, and they get a wholesale change with 2:14 to go. Trying to clamp this one down. Helas wants none of it. Trying to drag that one around Percy. Not happening. Now the Majors captain, Cizikas, takes a look. Sees Smith-Pelly, who's already got two with him. Stager steers that one wide. Smith-Pelly leaning, gets position on Maidens, and comes up with a puck.
One of Smith-Pelly's best games of the series, Dan. Best games of the playoffs tonight. Both ends of the rink.
I was going to say, overall, blocking shots, defensive play. And there on the forecheck as well, not giving any room. Anderson thinks about coming out. Canton says, I've got it. Off the boards, not out. And a high stick call coming up. Faceoff will be just outside the line. Down to 1:35 to go here in period number three of game one. And you wonder, as always, just what type of personality this series will take when it goes up to Owen Sound for game two.
Well, especially in the 1-1-1-1 format instead of the usual 2-2, I think it's easy enough to say, Dan, that nobody's in trouble and the series doesn't really get interesting until the home team loses. This score stays the same. Home team hasn't lost yet, and Owen Sound has not played at home, so game two now becomes of paramount importance. But hey, the final games in the league of the year, they're all important now as you have an offside the blue line.
Well, it's Stanish with a nice feed, but the reason that Joey Hischen was so far offside was, or so far in the clear, was because he was offside. Stager was gone to the bench with a buck 20 to go, and he'll stay between the hash marks to get there again as quickly as he can. And why not? The power play's been pretty effective for Owen Sound. It's it has its moments, though, Roger, tonight, where the majors have had some shorthanded opportunities, and I mean two or three of them.
Yes, McNardy with a pair of goals, but they also gave up a couple of big chances as well.
A couple of odd man rushes and a breakaway. Majors don't want to give Stager any room to leave. D'Souza almost caught top shelf, but off the glass. And now Canton backed up with 102 to go. Stager looks to the bench, but the majors have the puck. He can't go. D'Souza just ushers the puck in over the blue line. Doesn't need possession. Keeps the forecheck on. And here comes Stager as the attack gained the zone on the left side. Fleming man up with Hishon. Played back to the point. Petgrave holds it. No shot yet. Petgrave around one majors player. Petgrave coming down. Anderson's got an Owen Sound player down beside him. Can't get up. It's McNardy. 31 seconds to go. Majors up. 4-2 here in this third period. And with play along the boards like this, it could get nasty, but everybody comes away clean. And then Šemić loses it. Open net. And Mayer with an open net in 14 seconds to go will put it away. And the majors lead it 5-2 with 12.7 seconds to go.
So a little icing on the cake. Jordan Mayer finishes it off, but the majors are going to win game one of the OHL Championship Series, much to the delight of the home crowd, town crowd here. Overall, solid effort for Mississauga tonight. Owen Sound very competitive, but it's the majors fans that will do a little dancing and cheering in the stands here after game one. Mayer into the empty net at 19:48. And 5-2 Mississauga, game one about to go in the books.
Majors win the draw, and they have been a tough, tough team to beat in this postseason. They haven't lost often, and they didn't lose the opener. St. Mike's, Mississauga has a 1-0 lead on Owen Sound after game one, and the majors want the puck, and the attack won't let them have it. The referee wants the puck, and he's got a word of caution for the Owen Sound player, says, give me the puck.
Yeah, that kind of nonsense we're seeing more and more from players stealing the puck is a little juvenile. Like, you know, let the winning team.
You know who they're following.
Yeah, it's the NHL.
Well, Chris Pronger sent one of the worst examples of sportsmanship, and I don't care what his motive was, but now he's got every kid in junior hockey trying to do the same stupid thing.
Yeah.
Who cares? It's a puck. Let it go. Go home in front of your home fans and play one whale of a game. A good game tonight. Majors were just too deep and too much on opening night. But the attack going home are a tough, tough team. And this series is not going to be a sweep for anybody. I can guarantee you that.
No question. A tough opener. Score not maybe as reflective of the game, but it is a Mississauga win. It's a convincing win. And they have a 5-2 victory and a 1-0 lead in the best of seven OHL Championship Series. With their thoughts, let's go down to the panel led by Ben Ennis.
Thank you very much, Rod. So the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors fire the opening salvo of this OHL Championship Series 5-2 win over the Owen Sound Attack. I am Ben Ennis, joined by Peter Curtis and Matt Scooby atop the Hershey Center. Majors win it 5-2. Great game all around. The Majors controlled the play after that first period where they were tied at ones. A couple of power play goals, though, for the Owen Sound Attack, so maybe something to build on heading into game two.
Well, certainly in the Niagara Series, Mississauga was able to get away with taking a lot of penalties. They gave Niagara five power plays in three of those games. Owen Sound, they're going to have to be a little bit smarter about what they do out there. They don't want to give Owen Sound five power plays a game.
No, they don't want to do that. They also want to play a little better in that third period, too, as well. I think the Majors really have to play better in that third period. Two shots on goal, including that empty netter. So one shot on goal in all of 20 minutes, and it was really sloppy play. Not the methodical shut it down, an early goal for the attack, and then it was a power play goal that they could just get in through there. But it was also about, they got one shot on goal. You have to muster some kind of offensive ability, whether you're trying to shut things down or not. I think you have to be better than that in the third period.
Yeah, as far as a 5-2 game is concerned, the Owen Sound Attack were really in this game in the third period, trailing 4-2 for the most part after scoring that power play goal. Robbie McNardy with his second of the game from Sean Petgrave, and that came after Jamie Wise took that stupid penalty, I guess you could say. Especially a stupid penalty in the eyes of Dave Cameron at the 20-minute mark of the second period. Majors could not kill that off to start the third period, and it really looked like momentum was kind of slipping away from Mississauga with that power play goal.
Well, when you look at it, you're getting a power play at the end of the second period. You've got 18 minutes to come up with a strategy. You've got fresh ice. You've got an opportunity to regroup in the dressing room. Yeah, it was an unwise penalty. It'll be interesting. Dave Cameron has pulled a couple guys out every now and then on the third and fourth line. We'll see if Wise plays in games two. You know Coach Cameron, he's pretty tight on actions like that, so you might not even see him in game two.
Riley Brace are the best example of that to this point. We know we haven't seen Mika Partanen since I think it was game one of the third round of last series. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see what roster moves he makes, but I think that Owen Sound can draw off this third period as well. They had a good, solid third period. No, they didn't. They got a couple of scoring chances, maybe, you know, but it's about good teams finding a way to win. You know, it's essentially, you hate to use the cliche, but the Majors didn't play a very good third period. They had enough goals to get through it, but that's what it is at this point.
The captain had a goal. Casey Cizikas downstairs with Alicia Warner.
Thanks a lot, guys. Captain Casey Cizikas with me. Game-winning goal in the Majors 5-2 victory. How important was it to get this first win on home ice in the final?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It was definitely huge. A lot of guys, it's their first time here, so you know what? It's including myself. And you know what? Just to get that first one behind us with the effort that we had today, you know, it was definitely something that we're going to try and take into the game, too.
You talked about the fact that it's some guys' first time here in the final, and you're included in one of those guys, and you've been here the longest. Talk about that group of maybe three or four or five guys that have been here since the Toronto days that are finally seeing the finals for the first time, how it bonds you guys together.
We've been working towards this for a long time. You know, to finally get this first one behind us, you know, we were a little nervous in the first period. I think that kind of showed. But you know what, as the game went on, we got better and better, and you know, it was just a team effort tonight.
You come into a game like this, you guys both wrap your series up, your East and West Conference finals in five games. Did the rest maybe almost do more harm than good in terms, you talked about like maybe being a little too rusty. Did you find that affected you guys tonight?
I think it kind of showed in the first period. You know, you're off for a week and it kind of affects you, but you know what? I think once we got our legs underneath us and once we started working hard, you know, it started going our way. And we just got to take that into game two.
Last one for you. You haven't played these guys since November, back-to-back, like 8 days apart. So are you prepared at all, or what are you expecting going into Owen Sound? Because the atmosphere, of course, will be entirely different.
It's definitely going to be rocking up there in Owen Sound. You know, we just got to play the same way we did today. You know, we got pucks deep, we took the body, and, you know, I thought we played a great overall effort.
Casey Cizikas, captain of the Majors, in the 5-2 victory in game one here in the OHL final. We'll be back after the final on Rogers TV.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Since when did we start locking people up without a trial in this country?
I'm going to make him pay.
He has been held against his will for 6 years without a single charge being laid against him.
I am innocent.
He knew all the details, but he wasn't within 10 miles of the killing.
Why is that? Why is that?
It's the little things, Jimmy. It's the little things that rip you apart. It's the little things that get you caught.
This year will mark 10 years since the Owen Sound Attack won the OHL Championship. Relive every save, every goal, every hit from that seven-game series between the Attack and the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. Rogers TV will broadcast all seven games of the 2011 OHL Final from May 9th to the 15th.
Every year, dozens of Canadians are killed or seriously injured because they take risks around railway tracks. Talk to your loved ones about rail safety. Visit stoptracktragedies.ca.
Championship is in the books. Dan Dunleavy and Roger Lajoie upstairs as the Majors complete the victory here tonight in Game 1 in Majors fashion. Boy, we've seen every game this team has played this year, and we try to figure out what's different from one game to the next, and I know folks who watched every game are probably going to say, you know what,
nothing was different. Same from game one to tonight.
Yeah, they play the same way all the time, Dan, and it's been pretty effective. 53 regular season wins, 13 now in the playoffs. Hey, this team has won 23 of its last 24 games. Let's not forget that stat. I know that doesn't mean anything to Dave Cameron or the majors because it's 10 at the end of the regular season and 13-1 in the playoffs, but that's a chunk of winning hockey, and they don't do anything spectacular. There was nothing spectacular about tonight's win. Workmanlike effort. I thought Devontae Smith-Pelly was outstanding. Casey Cizikas as well. Credit to the attack. They answered back. McNardy had a couple of power play goals. They still feel good about their game. They're going back home to their arena with a great environment. First blood to the majors, but fans in Owen Sound and fans of this series can expect the same kind of game from the majors in game two. Whether that's good enough to win on the road, we'll see. But the majors do what the majors do, Dan. That's all there is to it.
If there's one strength to Owen Sound, it is their speed. It is that top line. If there's one weakness, and every team that faces Mississauga, Roger, has run into this, you have to be, and it's playoffs. Any team that's successful, you have to be able to roll more than just that one line to get you a goal. And you mentioned Marty Williamson brought this up when Niagara was in here. The thing about Mississauga is they have four top lines that can check and can score, and that's what Owen Sound found out tonight. A great start to the hockey game, but then it's as if the majors dare you to keep up that pace, and you just can't. It comes in spurts, and then the majors just take over.
Well, yeah, you look at the majors roster and people watching the game tonight, which is the checking line? Who checks the big line? Nobody. Everybody checks. It's four checking lines that can score. It's the way they do it. Now, some teams, you know, will say that at some point you need more of a star presence. Maybe teams built like that only go so far. Well, the majors will dispute that, Dan. They've got 66 wins and counting now as we head deeper and deeper into the OHL final. Again, full credit to Owen Sound. They played a good road game tonight. You're right. They started strong in the first period, but they could not answer the majors' depth in that second period. They could not answer the three goals. When they did get some chances, J.P. Anderson was there. Now the ball back in their court, home game, and I still say 1-1-1-1 format. The most important game in the series is game two because both teams will have had a game at home, and it's absolutely crucial, without question, that Owen Sound not only play better, but get the win on Thursday night.
No, you're right, and if you drop a game two, if you're headed home, you have that thought in the back of your head, okay, we're headed home, we can get that game back. And you're right, if you don't get it back, then you find yourself in a bit of a hole. The one thing, though, if I have to look at the majors, if I found a chink in the armor here tonight, and something I think Owen Sound can capitalize on, and I know they'll be all over Mississauga in game two because they're a well-coached hockey club, is the majors took some dumb penalties here tonight. Dave Cameron will talk to his team about that. Before we talk more about that, let's go downstairs as we go to the coaches' press conference.
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our post-game media conference following game one of the Rogers OHL Championship Series between the Owen Sound Attack and the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. I'd like to welcome all members of the media joining us here live at the Hershey Center in Mississauga, as well as everybody watching at home on the Rogers Action Pack, Cogeco TV, and Rogers TV. And at this point in time, we are joined by the head coach of the Owen Sound Attack, Mark Reeds, and attack forward, Robbie McNardy. And Coach Reeds, why don't we just start with you? Obviously, it's not the result that you were looking for tonight, but maybe you could just tell us some of the positives that you might draw from your team and what you might do heading into game two.
Well, I think you have to look at the first period. They score on their first power play opportunity. We respond on ours. It was a pretty wide open period for a final. There wasn't the physical play that was expected, and then we end up being up 10-5 in shots, and I think that we felt pretty good about ourselves. And I'm sure Dave had something to say in the dressing room, and they came out and dominated the second period. I mean, that's the difference in the game. They hemmed us in. They made it very difficult for us to get the changes. I mean, OHL was 21-7. They scored, three goals in that period. And, again, a turning point. They get the top line out against, arguably, my fourth line. But, we have our two best D out there. And for, Smith-Pelly to be able to just, skate through. And score that goal. I mean, that takes it's a little bit deflating.
And Robbie, for yourself, personally a strong game with two goals, but maybe you can tell us a little bit as one of the veterans in the dressing room, what the message that you would say or talk about with your teammates heading back home for game two.
Well, I mean, St. Mike's is probably the best at just playing hard for a full 60 minutes. And we have to know that we have to play every single shift as hard as we can because, like Mark said, I mean, basically they had a draw on their end and went straight down and scored. And, I mean, that's the top line of the league. And be aware against who you're playing against at all times. But definitely we can play with them. I think we probably were better in the first and third period. And just to let down the second cost us the game. But definitely we're in it to win it.
Thank you, guys. And at this point in time, I'd like to open it up to questions from members of the media.
Yep. Mark, obviously not the second period,
but well, obviously we weren't very pleased, with the period and the outcome. And again, you're in a championship series, we played hard all year and we're not just going to roll over, and it's about pushing back. And they talk about dominating in the trenches, and they did that period. And we had to get a little bit of pushback from our hockey club and light a little spark under their a number of ways. I mean, first game, I guess, in five days or so. And again, there's a feeling out process that takes place. And like anyone, you want to obviously, spend as much time in their zone as possible. And they did that in the second period. And that definitely grinds your players down as the game goes on. So, they got the result that they're looking for in the second, and we needed to have a response, a positive response at least in the third, to be able to carry something back to our building.
And do you expect that intensity to pick up this
game? It's not so much about it's more the intensity, and again, it's about playing 60 minutes. We've heard it time and time again throughout the playoffs so far, taking a couple of shifts off and what happens when you're playing St. Michael's and they capitalized on the opportunities. We made some soft plays and they took advantage of it. I don't think they had a very good game tonight, and they're going to have to respond in game two. And no disrespect intended to Mr. McNarty here. I don't really feel that they had a good night, and again, it's about skating and making things happen. I mean, when they're on their game, I didn't feel that they're skating as well as they normally do. And again, we'll have to kind of look at the game film and see if that's because the way they were playing against them. But I give all the credit in the world to the way St. Michael's played, but again. They need to step up and need to be better. Anything else?
I'd like to ask you to stick around as we'll be joined momentarily by Devontae Smith-Pelly and Dave Cameron of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. But gentlemen, thank you very much for taking the time and best of luck in game two.
So there you go. There is Mark Reeds and Robbie McNarty of the Owen Sound Attack. They lose game one, 5-2 to the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. And we talk about this game. It was tied after one, and there's no doubt that the Attack dominated that third period. And when you hear Mark Reeds talk about the fact that Owen Sound won the first and the third period, it's hard to argue against that.
Well, certainly they didn't have the greatest second period, but we were watching. We said there were some bad luck plays for them in the second period. I think he was being a little hard on his team right there. They had that strong first period where Smith-Pelly was able to score on the power play with that adjustment. Then the great passing play in the first, and at that point, it was a great road series for them.
They had a very good start to this game when you can come into the Hershey Center and be 1-1 with the Majors through 20 minutes. And then there's one of those bad breaks here that we're talking about. This puck just gets caught up in Jesse Blacker's hands. He can't find it, loses it, and then Smith-Pelly again on the doorstep from Sasek. It's a great feed, but again, another bad break for the attack at that point. And then it became, and then it was all Majors after this into the second period. Zeke is on the doorstep, a couple of whacks at it. He makes good. And again, this is kind of just like, it was two goals in 43 seconds because 43 seconds after this Zeke's goal, the Majors come back once more on the doorstep. Again, there's Chris D'Souza. So it's just like, then all of a sudden it's 4-1. So you can go do 3-1, 4-1 in a matter of seconds. And it really just was, it was all Majors in the second, and that's what hurt the attack. And you heard Reed saying that in the third period. They dominated that second period, and that's where they lost the game.
Yeah, absolutely. You give up three straight goals in that second period, that's the ball game as they lose it 5-2. But, I mean, if you look at it that way, and you only do play 20 minutes poorly, it's a 60-minute game, maybe you have a better chance to win than the final score indicated, but maybe something to build on at least heading into Game 2 in Owen Sound and then Game 3 coming back here in Mississauga on Friday. They got to use something as motivation.
Well, the power play having a great night there. And let's be honest, that Mississauga power play was on fire tonight. Yeah. Chris passing, and they were able to contain it. There was that one goal to start early, but the great part about playoffs is they've probably prepared for a week for a certain type of play that Mississauga is going to use. What does Dave Cameron do? He changes the power play, and they've got to make adjustments within 30 seconds on the bench. That's the great strategies here that Mark Reed and Dave Cameron, they're going to have to adapt to each other.
The top two coaches in the OHL are arguably Mark Reed, who was named the OHL Coach of the Year this earlier this week, but also, or sorry, a couple weeks ago, but also it's that high man. It was that adjustment. The high man in the slot, that was Devontae Smith-Pelly on the first line, kind of moving things around, and that's so hard to adjust to on the fly, like you said, Peter, when you look at film and you're committed to something for a week about it. So good on the coaching as well. But I like what Roger was talking about in Game 2. Game 2, I think, means a lot, especially in OHL series, because there's a game played at each home rink. So it's going to be a question now of whether the Majors can go to Owen Sound and win the game. And then it's also going to be a back-to-back game on Friday night, Game 3 here at the Hershey Center. So it'll be an interesting turnaround and interesting to see what happens in that second game as well.
Yeah, the Majors' power play looked good. Despite just the one goal, the Owen Sound attack did have a pair of goals on the power play, but I mean, you can look outside the numbers in this one. They just looked great, and a couple of great saves there by Scott Stager really kept the Majors from really blowing this thing wide open in that second period. He made a couple of great saves. I'm thinking of the one on D'Orazio, was outstanding. And Devontae Smith-Pelly, we talked about the changes the Majors are making on the power play right now. This is a big guy who's used to just mucking it up in front of the net, looking for rebounds on the power play. They set him up a little bit further away from the net in the slot, and there in that first period scores the power play goal on a long shot in the slot. So yeah, that is something that Mark Reed's and the Owen Sound attack probably going to have to look at going ahead to Game 2. But got word now that Dave Cameron is stepping up to the podium with Devontae Smith-Pelly.
All right, and welcome back to the second portion of our post-game media conference following Game 1 of the Rogers OHL Championship Series. And at this point in time, we're joined by the head coach and general manager of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, Dave Cameron, as well as Majors forward Devontae Smith-Pelly. And Coach Cameron, we'll start with you. A big win tonight, you know, for a large part on the back of a great second period. You had 21 shots and three goals. Maybe you can just talk about some of the successes that your team had overall tonight, and then specifically in that second period.
Well, I thought the game went pretty much like we thought. It was a back and forth affair. I thought in the first period we were sloppy and probably a little bit nervous with the layoff, and Owen Sound come right at us and had us back on our heels. I thought we regrouped well in the second period, and, you know, scored some goals, which generated some emotion and some energy, and then gave up that quick goal in the third period, and just kind of reversed where they got the energy and the emotion and the jump. But I thought we battled extremely hard in the third period to be able to pull out the win.
And Devontae, for yourself, great game tonight, two goals. Why don't you tell us a little bit about those two goals, as well as what it means to get a win under your belt in Game 1 here in Mississauga?
I think the first goal was just kind of us working around on the power play, and
went down to Cizikas, and I just kind of put my stick on the ice and tried to get a quick release, and it just so happened to go in. And the second one, it got caught in one of their D-man's gear, and we just kind of broke out on a 2-on-1. And again, Casey made a great pass, and all I had to do was kind of just tap it in. So, give a lot of credit to my line mates.
And what does it mean to get a win under your belt in game one of the Rogers OHL Championship Series?
It's huge. I mean, you never want to be down in the series. You like to start it off great, and I thought we played really well today, and it was nice to get the win.
At this point in time, I'd like to open it up to questions from members of the media. And we'll start up front here.
To get through the layoff and the nerves and things like that, and just a matter of relaxing a little bit. And sometimes when there's a layover like that, and they're almost too hyper to play. And when you're real hyper, it helps a little bit to spend some energy, kind of lose that edge a little bit, and you get a little more comfortable, which I thought we did in the second period.
Coach, could you just talk a little bit about the skill set that Justin Sugar's brought to the team this year, and what his past Memorial Cup experience might mean in the future?
When we make trades for players, we look at a combination of assets that the player brings. Obviously, skill. That's pretty easy to gauge, but we also want guys that have won, guys that know what it takes to win, guys that can play in pressure games, and we want guys that are good teammates, and he's all of the above.
Dave, Mark said he didn't think his best players were very good tonight.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch the first part of that.
Sorry. Mark said he didn't think his best players were very good tonight towards his line of Wilson, Hishon, and Fridge. What'd you think of their second line? Helmo, Shaw, and McNarty. They seem to be pretty, had you guys kind of on the ropes a little bit in the first period, seemed like.
He said Hishon and them weren't very good?
Yeah, he didn't think they were tonight.
Damn, trade deadline's gone, isn't it? Well, that's playoff hockey. It's you don't go this deep. The old cliches come out, your best players have to be your best players, but they're really good players, and maybe they didn't live up to Mark's expectations tonight, but they're good players. But the other players you mentioned are good also, and that's why they're in this championship with us, is that we have depth, and to be different players at different times will carry their teams. And I think McNarty, if you look at all their scoring and you subtract the power play goals off to get the 5-on-5 goals, I think McNarty had 30 goals total, 5 in the power play. So 5-on-5, he had 25, and I think Hishon was the same. So we recognized him as being a real good 5-on-5 player, and Healers and him compliment him.
Is there anything in that top line that you saw going into this series that maybe you guys could match up good against them in any way?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Was there anything in that first line that you saw going into the series that you guys matched up well against them?
No, I think it's characteristic of all top players or whoever's a top line in a given night, is you got to take their time and space away. You got to be physical on them. They're a good line because they complement one another, so you have to be aware of everybody that's on the ice. But they have no glaring weakness, that line, that's for sure.
Devontae, were you surprised at all the way you guys dominated the third period, that they came back with as much of a push as they did in the third?
The way we played in the second period, we knew that in the third period they come out hard, and they had us on the ropes for, the majority of the third period. And so, we knew that's how they're going to play, and they're probably going to try and continue that going into game two.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for joining us tonight, everyone. We invite everybody to join us for game two in Owen Sound coming up this week. And gentlemen, thank you very much. We appreciate you taking the time, and best of luck in game two.
All There you have it. The Mississauga St. Michael's Majors taking game one, 5-2 over the Owen Sound Attack. And gentlemen, just about 60 seconds before we have to wrap it. And a great start for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. Only one loss now in the playoffs. They have been spectacular. Pressure doesn't appear to be getting to them.
Well, Owen Sound knows they're going back into their own building with a goalie that can get them a win and get them back into this series.
And it really is. They're going back, and they really do need a win to get them back into this series. You don't want to go down 2-0 to the Majors at this point on the streak they've been on and how well they've been playing. But it's really about playing like they did in the first and third period. Keep the speed up. They match them very well when it comes to scoring, defensive hockey, and goaltending. It's a very good matchup, but they can't give up the big period like they did in the second tonight. Limit those scoring chances, and if they can limit, you know, the two goals in 43 seconds or the quick goals for the Majors to give them, you know, their kind of momentum going in, and I think they could be successful.
The Majors now have won 23 of their last 24 games, have only lost one game so far these playoffs. The Owen Sound Attack have only lost four and none at home, so game two certainly going to be a massive game in this series. We'll be back here at the Hershey Center on Friday. Majors win at 5-2.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Call the Rogers TV Viewer Response Line. Email us or connect with us on social media.
I'm Owen Sound Mayor Ian Vardy.